Let's just take you through the teams before the before the tannoy starts blaring all over us. In goal for Eastleigh, Joe McDonnell, a back three of George Langston, Ludwig Franchiletta and Trent Rendell. Bailey Clements and Enzo Baldovine on either side, with Solomon Wabuoke, Chris Maguire and Nigel Atangana in the middle. Goal-scoring magician Paul McCallum up top alongside Scott Quigley. For Ebbsfleet United, it's Mark Cousins in goal, Luke O'Neill, Hayden Hollis, Hayden White and Franklin Domi form a back four, with Chris Solly sitting just in front. Former Spitfire Oos Cisse is alongside Josh Wright in the middle, with Ben Chapman, David Amu and Darren McQueen leading the line. A different style here in National League football. Ebbsfleet United going with no formally recognised strikers.
Yeah, well, as we mentioned, Tom, earlier off commentary, it's could be a first in the National League. I've never witnessed a team here at the Silver Lake play without a designated number nine. Obviously, Eastleigh, very opposite. They rely heavily on Paul McCallum as a focal point, not only for goals, but in terms of holding up the ball and getting other players engaged. So two different sides, two different systems. Be interested to see how it pans out.
Other commentaries tonight on BBC Radio Solent. We've got Stoke City versus Southampton in the Championship. That's got an 8 p.m. kickoff. And alongside us, Portsmouth against Wickham at Fratton Park in League One. That's 7:45 as Pompey continue to hold on to the top spot in League One. Can they continue that this evening? Well, it's fantastic conditions. The pitch is just getting a last seeing to before we get to kick up, as the tannoy just announces that someone needs to move their car. Not the best start to an evening for that person.
Yeah, I was a bit worried it was yours there, Tom, but I think you're safe. Oh, no, you're safe.
That's mine, yeah. That's okay. Oh, yeah. Trust my car alarm to be the one going off later and the battery dies. The referee for this evening, we've got James Durkin. He's already taken charge of 5 National League games so far this season. Not shy of giving out a yellow, 21 so far. And here's an interesting one for you, Jack, just while the Tano does decide to blare out everywhere. Games involving Ebbsfleet this season have involved 5 red cards. Only one has gone to Ebbsfleet, so I'm expecting them maybe to know how to rile up the opposition.
Yes, I can imagine that might be a tactic and something Eastleigh might play onto. Obviously matching their kit colour in all red for Ebbsfleet, but away from home, that's the last thing you want. Coming to the Silver Lake is an early sending off, so I'm sure Ebbsfleet will be aware of that.
Players are now out. Oh, they've just come through 2 youth sides either side of halfway. Ebbsfleet look like they're going to be kicking from right to left. They're in their red shirts, white shorts, red socks. Eastleigh in their typical all blue home kit with white trim on the collar, as they just go through their paces just before we get to kick off, which is rapidly approaching here at the Silver Lake. Eastleigh, you know, again coming into this game in decent form. I don't know if you saw any of the highlights from the weekend. Enzo Baldovine's run for the 3rd goal for Paul McCallum.
Yeah, an amazing run, obviously. He's got abundance of pace and acceleration, and when he gets going, he's hard to stop. And you know, obviously got McCallum getting on the end of things. He's the main striker, then one to watch out in the National League as a whole. And I'm sure there's a few clubs sniffing around for him because he's such a prolific scorer, proven scorer in the National League. So hopefully he can add a few more goals this evening.
I just have to ask you before we get the game going. Obviously now Eastleigh are under permanent management. As a player, how does it play on your mind at all when you have someone interim in charge where you're not quite sure if they're going to be in charge next week, the week after? Does that play on your mind at all, or is it just cracking on with the job ahead?
I think it's more cracking on with the job ahead. Obviously, there is maybe even an argument to be said that it improves the game in terms of you wanting to showcase the interim manager or whoever might be watching from the stands to really showcase what you can do. So sometimes it can work in your favour. But I think at this level in the professional game and the professional standards that the players set, really, it shouldn't affect their game too much.
The referee, James Durkin, just waiting for everyone to get set, and we are about to get underway at the Silver Lake on a lovely, mild October evening. I think at the weekend it's meant to be 23 degrees. Time to get the shorts out.
That's factor 50 for me. That's 100%.
Yeah, you need to stay in the shade, Jack.
Absolutely.
Live commentary online on BBC Radio Solent. And we are underway at the Silver Lake. Eastleigh shooting from left to right as we look, as George Langston hits a long ball over towards that far side, which is just about kept in play. And then Eastleigh lose possession. Ebbsfleet have it with O'Neill in that right back position, and they'll start to get a bit of a feel for the ball as they play it across the back towards this near side, where the Albanian Franklin Domi gets it just short of halfway. And Scott Quigley will start the press, and he almost wins the ball as Josh Wright just tries to get the ball out to that far side, but it goes out of play for a Spitfires throw on halfway on that far side. Just over 34 seconds gone here at the Silver Lake. Live on BBC Radio Solent. Big evening of sports. Stoke and Southampton to come at 8 o'clock on 96.1 FM. And all of our Dorset frequencies. Pompey already underway at home to Wickham in League One. That's on Hants DAB and with our partners Express FM. Nigel Atangana into the centre circle. Quigley can't quite touch it, and Josh Wright will hit it out towards his right side as Ebbsfleet try and get the ball forward towards the edge of the box. Franchelletta just about gets ahead to it, and that carries the ball out towards this near side. But Ebbsfleet have a throw early on in line with the edge of the penalty area. Domi has it. No pace on the ball at the moment. Tries to play it into the middle, but quick pressure from Atangana just allows us. That's a nice flick. Edge of the box. Will David Amu try and turn it? He can't. And the ball goes all the way up to Paul McCallum on halfway. Is Mabwoke tries to feed Quigley down the left-hand side. He's in a bit of a foot race with Hollis, and he wins the ball. Edge of the penalty area, turns his man. Edge of the penalty area, can he get his shot away? He's got Maguire to his right, right of the D. Maguire lines up a shot, fakes and goes on his left. Now running into a bit of a cul-de-sac as Atangana feeds it out towards this right side. Boldervine up against Domi. Back to Atangana, who plays it into the centre of the Ebbsfleet half. As Maguire is just brought down, and that will be an early free kick for Eastleigh, about 30 yards out, in line with the edge of the Ebbsfleet penalty area, probably just around midway inside the Ebbsfleet half on this right-hand side. Good opportunity there, nice running there by Quigley.
It was, yeah, and again, ball fed into McCallum, set into the midfielder, and then Quigley pinging off the back four, and as you mentioned, just using his pace to accelerate away, and good counter-attacking football, and probably a common theme to look out for in this game.
A lot of men forward up from the back for Eastleigh. Atangana's on the edge of the box. I can see Messrs. Langston there as well. It's Chris Maguire that will be over this one.
It's quite a high line from Ebbsfleet as well. 18-yard box.
2.5 minutes gone here at the Silver Lake. Everyone bar one back for Ebbsfleet. The ball is whipped into the box. That's poor. Hits the only man in the wall. Goes up towards halfway where McQueen tries to win possession, and he's bundled over on the edge of the centre circle by Atangana. That's an easy free kick. And just disappointing delivery there from Maguire.
It was, wasn't it? It's criminal, isn't it? Hitting one man from a free kick in a promising position just wide of the 18-yard box. And Maguire's the most frustrated that he knows he can do better.
Ball forward down the left-hand side. Ebbsfleet get the ball into the box. At the back post there was Amu. It comes towards the edge of the penalty area. Eastleigh can't quite get it fully away. Josh Wright heads it to his left. And there's a bit of a high boot. The player's gone down. Nothing doing, says the referee. And Atangana tries to bring it over halfway. And here's a bit of a lash out there by Franklin Domi. And Atangana's down in a heap just inside the Eastleigh half. And I think Domi's going to have a bit of a word with the referee there. Already had 5 yellows this season. By the first week of September, the Albanian left back, and you can see why.
Yeah, well, it's a weird one, Tom. I don't know whether the ref's looking in for the tackle afterwards or for the dive whenever Domi appealed for the high foot there, but he seemed to go down before an EC player even put his foot in the air, so I'm not sure the ref liked that much, and I think quite rightly giving Domi the yellow card there.
I have to say, that's probably some sort of record to get your 6th yellow card and your first suspension already, and we're only in the first week of October.
It's not
that's
even Christmas, going. Yeah, you've got to be a bit more knowledgeable and wait until Boxing Day and then
well,
get
I tell
your Christmas
you what,
off.
With the price of first-class stamps going up, you're going to need to get those in early.
Absolutely.
Eastleigh have it back underway. Ludwig Franchelletta plays it back to Joe McDonald away to my left. Low ball forward is just about flicked on by Atangana down the left-hand side. It's actually a great ball. Another high foot. Nothing doing since the referee as Quigley goes down holding his face, but he gets back up off the turf as it's played down the left, and this now could be a chance for Ebbsfleet if they can just find support. 2 men on him. Back to Domi into the middle now, where it's collected by Chris Solly, the former Charlton defender. Josh Wright plays it out towards that far side. Chapman feeds it down the right side of the penalty area. McQueen has to come back. Still Chapman. Lines up Rendell and Langston. Cuts in on his left foot. Edge of the box. He's going to go for the shot. It's well over the bar. Danger signs there from Ebbsfleet, though. Nice little move.
Yeah, it was a good move out on the right-hand side here, and I think it was a tango just slipped over, which allowed the Ebbsfleet man to get a shot. But fortunately for Eastleigh, it was way off target. But promising signs there from Ebbsfleet, looking to play expansive football, really making the pitch big and trying to move the ball quite well. So, yeah, promising signs there from Ebbsfleet.
Certainly don't seem to be afraid of switching sides quickly. They certainly have the ability to do that, as they've just shown.
Yeah, definitely. And they've got experienced midfielders. Just mentioned the players played higher in the ladder, and he's comfortable getting on the ball and switching it in that kind of pivot role in the centre of the pitch. So he just needs to be aware of that.
Ball forward by McDonald. McCallum didn't win it, and it's rolled all the way out of play down by the corner flag away to my left. It's a Eastleigh throw. Live on BBC Radio. Solent 5.5 minutes gone at the Silver Lake Stadium. 0-0. I did say this game would guarantee goals with the clean sheet situation, but let's hope it doesn't end 0-0, that's for sure. Ball down the right by O'Neill, who scored in the 3-1 win against Boreham Wood at the weekend, but it goes all the way through to McDonald, and Eastleigh will build from the back. Nice turn from Bailey Clements. Signed only last week on a short-term loan deal from Chesterfield. Made his debut at the in the weekend win at FC Halifax. McDonald hits it up over halfway. Clear push in the back by McCallum, but the ball forward by Langston is picked up in the middle now by former Spitfire Usise. Plays it behind him to Domi, who's got a yellow card within the first few minutes, his sixth of the season. They opt to go all the way back to Mark Cousins, former Colchester goalkeeper. In his fluorescent pink kit, no one's going to be missing him. He looks like a salmon. Now, on this left-hand side, Ebbsfleet moving it forward over halfway with Cisse. He's got Domi to his left if he wants him. Boldervine hasn't quite tracked him, but now comes over towards him. Domi cuts inside on his right, tries to feed it down the left side of the box. Ball across. It might get to a foot, and it is! It's a goal! And McQueen has got himself a goal, his third in his last two games. The weekend now has got himself a goal within the first 7 minutes here at the Silver Lake. A lovely pullback left-footed shot from about 8 yards out, hit it into the far corner. Nothing Joe McDonald could do about that. Nice move. And here at the Silver Lake, it's Eastleigh 0, Ebbsfleet United 1.
Yeah, it was a good move on this left-hand side, Tom. Intricate combination play. And then you mentioned there, perfectly weighted cutback around the penalty box and just put away from McQueen right in the bottom left-hand corner. McDonald left with no chance, but from an Eastleigh point of view, far too easy. Shouldn't be allowed that much time to get a shot away unopposed. No one within 2 yards of him. So Eastleigh disappointed on that front, but Ebbsfleet dangerous in front of goal and clinical. 1-0 to them.
Another goal for Darren McQueen. He got himself into the non-league paper team of the week at the weekend, and why wouldn't you after a couple of goals and a good performance? But I have to say, it was really nice work by Domi, who cut in on his right, and definitely not what Eastleigh were expecting. He fed a lovely ball, something that you'd expect to see in the higher divisions. Really good vision there. But Eastleigh had to bounce back against Kidderminster in their last home game a couple of weeks ago. They're going to have to do that again. Boldervine coming down the right-hand side, on halfway, away from Chapman into the middle with Atangana, and Wright is quick to press Clements in the middle. Nabuoke wins the ball on in the centre circle, gets it back. Eastleigh just need to calm down. They're looking a little bit flustered at the moment. Atangana just showing that with a bit of a loose ball, but it's well collected by French Letter under no pressure. Opts to go long down the right side in search of McCallum and Quigley, but that's going to be let to roll out of play harmlessly. Away to my right for an Ebbsfleet goal kick. Ebbsfleet, the visitors, lead 1-0. Live on BBC Radio Solent, 8.5 minutes gone here at the Silver Lake.
Yeah, we mentioned before kickoff as well, Tom, about those inverted wingers of Ebbsfleet, and sometimes without playing with a designated nine, you can sometimes miss that focal point, that presence in and around the box. But the way Ebbsfleet for their goal got men in and around that 6 yard box was brilliant, and obviously McQueen was on hand to put it away, and you know, it's a really effective move from them.
Hayden Hollis brings it out from the back, plays it to his left to White. No real press at the moment from Eastleigh. Into the middle to Cisse, left of centre. McCallum offers a foot. Chapman turns away from his man brilliantly. It's assisted the first goal. Tries to thread it through down the middle, but Trent Rendell read that well. He needs to get it clear, the QPR loanee, up towards halfway. Header from Quigley. Tries to flick it to Maguire, who doesn't quite have the pace to get on that. And Hayden White will play it out towards the right side to O'Neill. Tries to skip away from one challenge. Nice one-touch football by Ebbsfleet in the middle. Cisse now has it left of the centre circle. Brings it forward over towards his left. Domi for company. Up against Boldervine, the Albanian has it. Cuts in towards the edge of the box, and that's away from his man. And Bolivine now can bring it away for the Spitfires up towards halfway. Quigley, first time touch with the edge of his right foot. Bolivine trying to get on that, but it's well read and goes out of play on this near side. Chris Solly using his experience to get that out of play as Bolivine will come and collect this midway inside the Ebbsfleet half on this near side. 10-minute mark has gone. Ebbsfleet lead 1-0. That goal from Darren McQueen. Turn from Quigley on the edge of the box, right side. Back to Maguire, right of centre, midway inside the Ebbsfleet half. Atangana feeds it to Bolivine, up against two men. Back to Atangana, first time ball, that's poor. Although the defence have got really underneath that. Coming down with snow on that one, and the header by Atangana is harmless, and we'll go out for an Ebbsfleet throw down to my right. Ebbsfleet for a midweek game, brought a good smattering of away fans away to my right in that far right hand corner, making some good noise so far. They would have liked what they've seen so far, and I have to say they've played some wonderful one-touch football so far, Jack.
They have, and they've done such a good job in dragging out the centre-backs of Eastleigh and then exploiting the space that they've left.
Maguire tries to run the ball down the right hand side. Is he going to win himself a corner from his endeavour? He does, and Eastleigh will have a corner down to my right. Good opportunity for them to get themselves back into the game early on. It'd be the perfect response. McCallum scoring from a corner against Kidderminster that got them back on level terms just a couple of weeks ago. Can Maguire get a better delivery into this one after a fairly shoddy one for his set piece earlier? In comes the delivery towards the front post, onto the head of Maguire. Does it come off him last? It does, says the linesman. Goal kick to Ebbsfleet. 11 and a half minutes gone, live here on BBC Radio Solent. Not the start that the Spitfires would have wanted, but Ebbsfleet showing their class so far. And what I like about them so far, Jack, is that they're very confident on the ball, really confident. You can see why they got over 100 points in the National League South, as they just try and feed the ball down the left channel, but it's blocked, and Eastleigh will try and get it over halfway with Atangana. Leaves his foot in on Chapman, and Chapman stumbles and wins himself a set piece on halfway. Much to the chagrin of Nigel Atangana, as Chris Sonny plays a beautiful ball out towards that far side.
He's done that so well, hasn't he, so far, Tom? He's just sat the Ebbsfleet captain, sat as the deepest midfielder, got on the ball and just sprayed it left to right or right to left across the pitch. He's been allowed too much time on the ball so far.
He's just sitting ahead of the defence and using that Football League experience. You can see it in spades. He spent most of his career at Charlton Athletic, and you can definitely see that he's been plying his trade in the higher division for quite some time. Really cultured right-footed pass. Lovely to see at this level, but Eastleigh, they've got to get on him quick. They've got to make sure that he can't settle into any rhythm, which he so far seems to have done. Chapman over halfway, tries to play it down the right-hand side, and here they come at pace. Down the right, low shot into the midriff of Joe McDonald, who got down well to his right, but again, Ebbsfleet not afraid to collect possession and run forward with it, but they have it in possession down the right-hand side. Eastleigh can't quite get it away. David Amu to O'Neill, tries to feed it down the right channel, cuts in on his left, back to Amu, former Liverpool forward. Solly just dictating play at the moment. O'Neill back to Solly, about 30 yards from goal on the right side, shapes to put the cross in but doesn't. Now it is O'Neill, cuts in on his left foot, edge of the box, Josh Wright feeds it back to Domi, left of the D. Is he going to take it to his left? He does, shoots, it's blocked by Bolivine well, but the attack continues. Domi into the penalty area, nice touch, can they get a shot away? They can't, and Atangana slips on the edge of the box as he tries to get it away at pace, and eventually Eastleigh get it up towards halfway, and Chris Solly is able to mop that up and just coolly plays it out towards the left side. He's certainly in charge, he's the conductor at the moment, he's dictating the speed, the tempo, as the ball is fed down the right-hand side for David Amu. Back towards the edge of the box. O'Neill in a crossing position, but he's going to feed it down the right-hand side. Blow ball in, goes out of play for a corner on that far side. 14 minutes gone. Ebbsfleet starting to turn the screw once more. They're looking confident, they're looking sharp, and Eastleigh at the moment are all sixes and sevens.
Yeah, they are, Tom. It's first period in this game of real sustained possession inside the Eastleigh half, and Ebbsfleet haven't gone long once. I've been really impressed with how they started this game. Moved it so well, moved it left to right, waited for the Eastleigh to commit, and then just used the space that they've left to exploit and play them behind them. Little one-touch passes, like you say, Tom. It's been great to watch, but Eastleigh at the moment getting pulled apart, and they need to make sure they address this quickly.
Ebbsfleet have certainly come here and not really shown respect to their National League neighbours at the moment. Just a point behind as the corner comes in towards the front post. Bit of a goalmouth scramble, and Atangana will try and bring it away inside the box. He takes a touch to his right, and that's poor. Josh Wright picks it up 30 yards from goal. To his left to Cisse. Tries to get it down that left channel. Nice turn down the left-hand side. Up towards the byline, back to right, left of the edge of the penalty area. His ball forward towards Domi has a little bit too much on it. It goes out of play for a goal kick to Eastleigh. But again, Ebbsfleet playing with pace. They're very direct. They know what they want. Eastleigh at the moment just sort of hacking it clear. No real direction, Jack.
Yeah, definitely. And they haven't really got an out ball, have they? McCallum's left a little bit isolated, and it was a Tanga just then tried to play the ball up to him, but immediately there's three red shirts just surrounding McCallum. He's not able, doesn't allow Eastleigh to get up the pitch, and at the moment Ebbsfleet are really dictating the play.
1-0 Ebbsfleet lead as McCallum finally gets himself a free kick for being dragged down after going for a header. Midway inside the Ebbsfleet half, just right of centre, and I'm sure Chris Maguire will be hoping for a much better delivery than the last one.
It's an identical area, isn't it, Tom? I think it's exact same spot, right of the 18-yard box. Maybe a little bit deeper this time, but good area for Eastleigh to send up the centre-backs and maybe try and create something out of nothing from this game.
The likes of Langston, Wabuoke in the D on the edge of the box. Maguire into the penalty area, headed from McCallum! 1-1! Easy as you like from Paul McCallum, back on level terms. Stooped, headed it out. Mark Cousins, the keeper, was completely wrong-footed and the ball just rolled into the back of the net. That's exactly what the doctor ordered. Eastleigh 1, Ebbsfleet 1.
Said earlier, Tom, that can pull something out of nothing, and he's the man that can do it, isn't it, Paul McCallum? Half-decent ball in the box from Maguire, and then Paul McCallum just uses his strength to get across his man and heads it brilliantly into the near post, and the keeper left with no chance. But again, against the run of play, you might say, but Eastleigh won't care. Fantastic head from McCallum, back 1-1.
Got himself the 6 goals in his last 6 games, certainly in a rich vein of form, and I just love the way that he stooped for that. The ball came to him sort of almost midriff height, and he just managed to get him, and I think that's what caught the goalkeeper out. As they try and play it down the right-hand side, Ebbsfleet, towards Amu. Can they look to retake the lead early on after just giving it away? Amu is in very much a cul-de-sac. He goes down, doesn't win anything, throw into Eastleigh. But, yeah, just going back to that goal, it's about 12 yards out, and I think the keeper is completely wrong-footed. He wasn't expecting that to come in. It was such a low ball into the penalty area.
It was, and usually McCallum's known for his leaping ability and back-post headers, but that time, as you said, Tom, just getting in front of his man at the near post and then just guiding it, you know, not much power, just guides the header into that near post, and keeper left with no chance, and the zip on the pitch, really quick pitch, just guided it, helped it into the goal, and again, against the run of play, Eastleigh find themselves back in this game.
The ball is currently on halfway, just short of the centre circle, in possession with Hayden Hollis at the back for Ebbsfleet. O'Neill on that right-hand side. Right ball, trying to just loft it towards the edge of the box with Chapman. McQueen picks it up on the edge of the penalty area, and he is sliced down on the edge of the box. That's a really nasty challenge. Running at pace forward, and he's won himself a free kick, I'd say about 20, 25 yards out, just out to the right of the D. Very dangerous position.
Yeah, very dangerous position this, and I think it's a Tanga. He might be lucky to get away without a booking. I'm not sure he is. But again, dangerous position this. Very central in the goal.
He does get the booking, does Nigel Atangana. But very quickly, Ebbsfleet going direct. And I have to say, that right foot of O'Neill is looking very dangerous. Whipping it across the back line, so it sort of almost goes offside, then comes back onside to be collected. And the knockdown, they're first to it. And that allowed McQueen just to race onto that. And I think he was going to have a pop from about 20 yards. Was ready to pull the trigger. And then it was just hacked down.
Such a hard ball to deal with, Tom. Speaking as a centre-back myself, when it gets played behind you at an angle, like you say, curved, and you find yourself as a centre-back running towards your own goal, which you never want to do, makes it really awkward to clear, and absolutely done well getting around these centre-backs to pick up the second balls.
O'Neill is over this. He looks like the front man to be taking this, the right back. Already 3 goals this season. He does curl it towards the top corner, harmlessly over the bar. Joe McDonald didn't even really look very worried by that. And the danger's gone for Eastleigh.
Tanga just needs to be careful now, though, on a yellow card. Obviously, absolutely done well playing the ball into midfield, just that gap between the midfield and the back four of Eastleigh. So he just needs to be careful now. a good 70 minutes left in this game. Just needs to be cautious.
Wouldn't be surprised if it was 80 with the amount of added time this season.
Very true.
Up by Joe McDonald, over towards halfway. Cisse heads it up, trying to find the head of the move. Has to crouch down for that. Chapman keeps the move alive towards McQueen, who opened the scoring inside the first few minutes. Clements with a nice little jinking run down the left-hand side and then plays a poor ball in search of McCallum. And it's well intercepted by Hollis. Lofts the ball out towards that right side to O'Neill. In the middle now with Chris Solly, who just getting another feel for the ball. He's done really well so far, very cultured right foot. Ebbsfleet want to get it forward, and the defender is just telling his players he wants more runs, as Eastleigh have it in possession on halfway. Chris Maguire manages to get away from the challenge of a couple of men and is given away by Atangana. A poor couple of minutes for him. Ebbsfleet have it bang in the centre of the pitch with Josh Wright. Over towards that right-hand side, where it's picked up by O'Neill. He takes it past Clement, down the right side. He makes an overlapping run, doesn't receive the ball. Solly has it bang in the centre of the Eastleigh half, feeds it nicely out towards that right channel. O'Neill sort of gets himself set. He can't quite get the cross out of his feet, and the ball will be kept in play on that far side by Wright. Just ahead of him, about 5 yards, is O'Neill. One touch play on that far side eventually comes to Ebbsfleet's undoing, and it'll be a Spitfires throw midway inside their own half on that far side. BBC Radio Solent, 21 minutes gone. Scores currently 1-1. Paul McCallum getting the Spitfires back on level terms after Darren McQueen getting his third in two games with a lovely left-footed shot across the face of goal as Quigley wins the ball over halfway, racing towards the edge of the box. He goes down, free kick, and another dangerous position here for the Spitfires, left of the penalty area, the left corner of the box. Chris Solly's already come over the captain to dispute that, but there's no way the referee's going to be doing anything other than just, well, if he had the foam, put the foam down, but he clearly doesn't have that. And Chris Maguire has another opportunity to whip a ball into the penalty area.
Yeah, it was really clever play that from Quigley, wasn't it, on the left-hand side. Didn't have a lot of options, just ran with it outside, left of the 18-yard box, and then felt the contact from the Ebbsfleet defender and went down when there wasn't a lot of options for him. So that was probably the best result for him, as he had this free kick just wide of the 18-yard box now. McCallum territory, you might say.
I'd say he's currently licking his lips. He's just stood short of the penalty spot. Just stood in an offside position in a world of his own thoughts, I'd say. Just how can I get my head onto this one?
Looks confident, doesn't he? Looks very confident.
He's walking away from everything else. There's sort of a line of red and blue shirts, I'd say about 14 yards across the edge of the D, as it were. But free kick for Eastleigh over on that far side, just coming up to the 23rd minute. Chris Maguire, left arm goes up and it hits the wall again. And the Scot will get the rebound about 30 yards from goal. Ball into the penalty area. McCallum, left side, back to goal. Has to play it back to Maguire, and Eastleigh will go and build again with Boldevine in the centre circle. Lofted ball forward in search of McCallum, and it just goes wide of the Eastleigh goal scorer. Mark Cousins does well to come out in his all pink kit and bowls it out towards the right side as Ebbsfleet come forward. O'Neill looking for the switch over towards this near side, brought down well by Josh Wright. Lovely switch of play into Chapman, who turns away from Francioletta and spreads to the play out towards that far side, where O'Neill will pick it up. Bit of turn of pace to get away from Maguire. Chapman edge of the penalty area, the touch evades him, and Eastleigh trying to get it away with Atangana. He has to go back to his goalkeeper McDonald. He first time hoofs it up towards halfway. Bit of a coming together, and of now the referee blows. Very delayed there, Jack. It was at least about 5 seconds before he decided he wanted to give that, and Ebbsfleet have a free kick just shy of the centre circle, right of centre.
Yeah, I think probably the right decision there. Referee just taking his time to come to that conclusion. Just put the arm across him, and sometimes those arms can be a little bit loose and catch you in the face, and I think that's the outcome here. But no real complaints from the AC players, really.
24 minutes gone, live on BBC Radio Solent, online on your smart speaker and the BBC Sounds app. Player currently down with a bit of an injury, so that's why we've got a bit of a stoppage. So just have a look at scores elsewhere this evening. No goals in the Champions League as of yet, apart from in the earlier kickoffs. Not really concerned with our side. Southampton Stoke, that remains 0-0 at the moment. And Pompey in League One, also goalless with Wickham. Josh Wright is over this one. Midway inside the first half. Eastleigh 1, Ebbsfleet United 1. Whistle goes. Line of Eastleigh defenders just outside the penalty area, about 25 yards out. Long ball deep, headed up into the air, towards the edge of the box. Domi will head it forward. Langston deals with it well, towards the edge of the box. Maguire's chest puts it back in a dangerous position, but the diminutive Scott wriggles away from one challenge on the right corner of his own box, and then he loses it. And Chapman now across the face of the penalty area. McQueen will hit it with his right foot. It takes a deflection, and that takes all the pace out of it. Goes into the midriff of McDonald, but dangerous play by Chris Maguire on the edge of his own penalty area. I know you've got EFL experience, but you really can't be doing that so close to your own penalty box.
No, you can't, but I think the reason behind it is just, again, McCallum's a little bit isolated when Ebbsfleet get bodies around the Eastleigh box, and then Eastleigh do win it. They haven't really got the out ball to McCallum, so they had to risk their Maguire playing balls in front of his own 18-yard box to try and allow Eastleigh time to get out and try and keep the ball rather than just hoofing it back to into Ebbsfleet's half.
However, if you're in that position, Jack, are you just hitting it into row Z?
Oh, yeah. Heading it and kicking it. Row Z. Bang. Thank you very much.
Head down.
Yep.
Someone's pie has just dropped out of their hands. Ebbsfleet come forward. Chapman, who's done really well to go across the face of the forward. Low ball into the penalty area towards the edge. McQueen with the shot. It bounces just wide. Oh, that was a really good chance there. McDonald, sort of a delayed dive for that. He must have thought it was going wide. He must have been fairly confident. Dangerous from Ebbsfleet, just a couple of passes and suddenly they were on the edge of the box with a dangerous opportunity.
Yeah, and it's his own man, the Ebbsfleet winger, I think it was, who ended up blocking it from his own teammate. But again, intricate pass in there from Ebbsfleet on the right-hand side, finds a pass inside just short of the 18-yard box, and then fortunately for Eastleigh, the shot was off target. But again, dangerous sides. Ebbsfleet's build-up play has been really impressive in this first half.
Quick one-touch football as there's a coming together in the middle, and Ebbsfleet will get it going quickly right out towards the far side, where O'Neill will bring it over halfway, has to go back towards the centre circle, right steps on the ball, plays it back to O'Neill, the former Southend right back, also ex-Burnley, his long ball forward in search of Domi, but across comes Enzo Baldwin in that right wing back position, back towards his own corner flag, lets the ball roll out of play harmlessly, and that'll go out for a goal kick. Well dealt with by Baldwin there.
Yeah, well, I was just thinking, Tom, that you said ex-Burnley and then long ball after each other. I think that's
Sean Dyche would be very proud.
Go hand in hand, I think, those two.
Trying something different now under Vincent Kompany, and it just doesn't suit them, does it?
No,
you know,
no, I miss the days of cold nights, Tuesday nights at Turf Moor.
Someone's car is now blocking an entrance and exit. Someone is they're trying to get the owner of this vehicle, but no one's sort of letting their embarrassment know at the moment. Across halfway comes Baldwin as Eastleigh bring it forward. Across comes Cisse, and Atangana's touch is poor again. He's had a bad game so far, but he does win it. McCallum keeps the move alive. Quigley now bang in the centre of the Ebbsfleet half as Wabwoke tries to get it out towards the left side, and quickly in comes O'Neill sliding in, and Ebbsfleet have it back in possession now. David Amu. So O'Neill slips as he feeds it into the middle of the pitch as it's collected by Cisse, left of the centre circle. He's got Domi to his left, making an overlapping run up against Baldwin. Quick ball into the centre, across comes Atangana, and Eastleigh do well just to play it out from the back, and then a loose pass from Franceletto. It goes harmlessly out for a throw. Edge of the penalty area, tries to be brought down now by McQueen down the right side, doesn't have many options, and he takes it down the left now with Amu. Chapman tries to line up across. Solly, all this play down by my left. Cisse, his ball is poor, and now McCallum's going to chase a ball down the right hand side, but he's never going to get on the end of that, and the ball goes all the way back to Mark Cousins in the Ebbsfleet goal. Hayden White now brings it away. Chris Solly spreads a pass out towards that far side. O'Neill seems to be the target for any attack that gets going. He's got a fantastic right peg on him so far. He's played some wonderful crossfield balls and obviously has a good understanding down that right channel.
Just really patient as well, Tom, aren't they? How many passes is this between the back four of Ebbsfleet there? Just shifting easy side to side, waiting for the right opportunity to play it through and draw them out. Very patient in possession, Ebbsfleet.
Only collected 4 points away from home this season, and you have to say that doesn't really suit them as the dink ball over the top. McQueen's racing onto it. McDonald comes out and collects that. Good anticipation from the Eastleigh goalkeeper. And again, just out of nothing, one ball over the top, and Ebbsfleet get themselves in behind.
It's the movement off the ball that Eastleigh got to be so aware of, Tom. They're dragging Eastleigh defenders in areas they don't want to be, into the midfield areas, into wide areas, and then exploiting the space. They tried it there with a run from McQueen, but fortunately for Eastleigh, the pass wasn't quite there. It was a little bit overhit, but again, off the ball, Ebbsfleet's movement's been really, really sharp, really done with a purpose.
30 minutes gone here, live on BBC Radio Solent. We're actually going to need a new ball as someone's kicked it all the way and it probably landed on a runway at Southampton Airport. Doesn't take much, though, to get the ball out of this stadium.
No, that's fair to say. I'd be having a field day out there, Tom.
I tell you what, you'd probably be having to pay for each replacement there.
I don't know about that.
Left-hand side, Domi now midway inside the absolute half, back towards halfway, where Solly for once actually has a poor touch, and that allows Maguire just to pounce and get it out of play for a throw on halfway. It will go Ebbsfleet's way, and Domi, who picked up a yellow inside the first few minutes, decides that he doesn't want to go back to his goalkeeper. I haven't really seen that too often. Obviously, you normally think that players want to grab at least 20 extra yards down the line. He decided he wanted to go back as he plays it into the middle to Chapman. He seems to be popping up everywhere. Josh Wright. Pass out towards the right-hand side. Here comes O'Neill towards the edge of the penalty area. Towards the edge of the box. It can't quite find the feet of McQueen. The header forward by Waboke doesn't find the man that he wants. And Cisse will hit it to his left. And that's gone just behind Domi, and it's a good skip there from Boldevine into the middle to Maguire. He can turn and plays it down the right hand side to McCallum, but quickly comes back the Albanian Domi, and that ball from Maguire is really poor into the middle. He didn't look when he played that pass, and Josh Wright will have it. Ebbsfleet in possession on halfway. The ball forward by O'Neill takes a deflection, goes out of play on that far side, but it's just sloppy, isn't it?
Yeah, and again it comes back to Ebbsfleet having good spells of possession in Eastleigh half, and then Eastleigh winning it, and must be too tired, or you know, too many red shirts around them to really get the decent quality ball into McCallum and get them up the pitch. So again, it just falls back to a red shirt, and Ebbsfleet build another attack.
Captain Solly in possession, White across the back four towards Hayden Hollis. Domi, lovely flick infield, and Cisse's touch just about gets to the man he wants, to David Amu. Now Solly picks it up once more, right of the centre circle, out towards Wright. Nice movement again. McQueen gets bundled to the floor, wins himself a free kick. Referee James Durkin has no problem in immediately giving that one. That looked fairly... I tell you what, McQueen is getting battered out there today.
He is, but he won't mind. He's got his goal. He's still looking threatening. Looks like he's scored another. Still dragging the EC defenders into areas they don't want to be in, giving fouls away like that. He's enjoying himself out there at the moment, McQueen.
Free kick out on the right, midway inside the Eastleigh half. They choose not to whip the ball in the box and go short right. Down the right-hand side to Chapman. He can get to the byline. Can he beat his man? He does get a ball in the box, but it's cleared low by Eastleigh. And that one goes out of play on the far side, and we're going to need a third ball of the evening.
Feeling sorry for the Eastleigh get man here. He's got a job in his hands, replacing these. I know how crucial value footballs are at clubs.
I'll tell you what, the kit man's probably going to be looking around and hoping that someone's got a spare ball in their boot of the car at the moment.
I've got a size 3, but I'm not sure it'll make much of a spectacle out of it.
Certainly would be some kind of spectacle, that's for sure. Ebbsfleet have it down the right hand side. They can't quite work a ball into the box and play it into the middle of the half to right. Bit of pressure there from Scott Quigley, who's been quiet so far in this game. But Ebbsfleet still have it, and that's a lovely switch out towards the right side. Not lovely enough for the offside flag to go up and for the linesman to ruin that move, but Eastleigh won't care. That just disrupts Ebbsfleet's rhythm somewhat. Coming up to the 34-minute mark, live on BBC Radio, Solent online, and on your smart speaker in the BBC Sounds app. 1-1. And considering how Ebbsfleet have played so far, I think the Spitfires will be fairly happy to go into half-time levels on level pegging. Good crowd here tonight. Someone banging the drums. Long ball forward in search of Chris Maguire. He's never going to win that header. The ball comes back to Waboke. Middle of the Ebbsfleet half. Quigley now towards this near side to Boldevine. He's got two men on him and goes back to Atangana about 30 yards from goal in the middle. Waboke gets away from the challenge of Cisse. Now Boldevine. A few triangles of play going on with Atangana. Wabwoke in the middle, and Eastleigh having to go back towards halfway after gaining some ground. They have to start again. Langston plays it out towards the left-hand side to Bailey Clements, another player who's not really had many touches of the ball so far. Atangana. A few disgruntled moans just coming from the Eastleigh fans as Eastleigh can't quite get the ball into the dangerous positions. Ball forward by Mwabwoke is well dealt with, but Rendell will pick it up on halfway, and again an aimless ball forward, and Chris Solly will just mop that up, and here come Ebbsfleet down the right side. Switch of play by O'Neill, goes over the head of Chapman and goes out of play on this near side for an Eastleigh throw, but again in the middle, not taking a touch, just playing that first time ball and no one in the vicinity to collect it.
Yeah, and you've got to be careful because Ebbsfleet on the break do look quick going forward, quick to exploit the counter attack, and like you say, Tom, just a little bit of lack of quality at the moment from Eastleigh. When they do get it, just unable to retain possession. Just need to find a way to be able to get the ball to a blue shirt and build a bit of possession in the Ebbsfleet half.
Ball bounces over Quigley, but Spitfires have it back with Atangana.
That's better.
Nice switch of play there from George Langston across the back four to Clements. Into the middle, top of the D is Atangana. Forward to Quigley, who picks it up inside the Ebbsfleet half. The ball comes off his knee, and a bit of frustration there from Scott Quigley, brings down Solly. You can certainly understand why he's a bit frustrated and has lashed out. He collected the ball, it was a nice turn. The ball's just hit him on the shin or the knee, taking it away from him, and the move has just gone out of his grasp.
Yeah, it's frustration with himself, like you say, Tom. His first touch just let him down there and bounced off his shin or knee and go to the Ebbsfleet man. Frustrated with that, but he's doing a good job of winding up the Ebbsfleet pack four at the moment.
I mentioned Franklin Domi getting his sixth yellow of the season, but Scott Quigley himself is on five. Missed the Bromley game through suspension, so you can certainly see why he's getting in the referee's book, and they probably know his number.
He looks like he enjoys it as well, winding up the defenders, which isn't necessarily a bad trait in a striker.
No, you want to get them riled up, don't you? And that seems to be, with Ebbsfleet's record so far of five red cards involved in their matches and only collecting one themselves, they know how to rub up the opposition the wrong way. And I can understand, actually, with the pace of McQueen as well, just turning his man, getting brought down, that probably gobbles up yellow cards. As Eastleigh have it in the centre with Boldevine, and he just turns into Cisse. No man on cry. And it will be on this near side with Ben Chapman as Chris Solly, who's doing really well as sort of that anchor in front of the back four, just to come across wherever he's needed. Long ball over towards O'Neill. Well collected by McQueen, and he darts away from his man, and he's coming forward with pace, but there's still a bit of a challenge to get past if he can. Ebbsfleet still have it possession on that far side as they try and keep the move recycled. Wright runs into a player, and I think as the whistle went, I think he has won himself a free kick on that far side.
I think that's quickly sixth yellow card of the season there as well, Tom.
Easy one. Well, we were just talking about it, so well done, Scott.
Courtesy of you there, Tom.
Yeah, commentator's curse there. I do apologise, Scott. Let's just hope the seventh is quite some time away, otherwise he's still going to find themselves a mountain to climb. 38-minute mark has just ticked over here at the Silver Lake, live on BBC Radio Solent. A chance for Ebbsfleet to whip the ball into the box. Free kick's on that far side. They take it short to O'Neill. Plays it back towards Wright. Tries to feed it down the right-hand side of the penalty area to Amu. Wright wriggles into the penalty area. Really good move, and the ball is deflected out of play. Eventually, it's collected on that far side by Mwabwoke, but nice fast passing there from Ebbsfleet. Eastleigh, they just need to get some control on the game as Rendell does well to turn away from his man. Didn't really have any options, but now here's Chris Maguire. Spreads it over towards this near side. Frangioletta steps over the ball, tries to get it away from Chapman. Maguire's come over and turns away from Solly. Well, outside of the right foot, ball down the right channel. Quigley's made a run. Boldevine's gone inside. I have to say that Hollis has come across well, read that cut back from Quigley, but it will be a Spitfire throw in line with the edge of the box on this near side.
Well, they get back into good shape really well, don't they? As soon as they lose it, they get into a really good defensive unit, really hard to break down. Hollis there, getting out on the left-hand side, providing cover.
Boldevine on this near side. Frangioletta passed back to him. First time ball into the box for McCallum, but it's just going to come to Solly on the edge of the penalty area. He hits up towards halfway. Trent Rendell collects it, and Eastleigh will recycle it. Clements out towards this near side. That's a nice ball. Boldervine lofts it towards the head of McCallum. McCallum gets it above his defender, quickly takes it away from him. McCallum, does he get it over the line? Referee says yes! And Eastleigh have got the lead here at the Silver Lake. My oh my. Long ball by Boldervine towards the back post. McCallum headed it across goal. Across came Quigley. The touch took it away from the penalty area. Got it back to McCallum. He then just toe-poked it towards goal. Mark Cousins was frantically flapping, trying to stop it from going over the line. He wasn't able to. And with just short of the 40th minute mark, 5 minutes before half-time, Eastleigh have come from behind to lead 2-1. Paul McCallum.
Well, his first goal wasn't very McCallum-like, but that one was textbook McCallum, wasn't it? Peeling off at the back post, ball was on the right-hand side, just peeled off his man, headed it. It wasn't fortunate the first time, and then second time, lucky in the corner of there and off the post. Good from the linesman there, spotting that it was over the line. But again, textbook McCallum, just so good in the air there, just peeling off his man and heading it down to make it really awkward for the goalkeeper to deal with. And a second goal for McCallum, 2-1 Eastleigh.
Paul McCallum now on 9 goals for the season, 4 goals in his last two, well, 1.5 matches. As the ball forward is quickly, bit of play, and there goes, he say, the offside flag goes up. I have to say, that's very much against the run of play, really, Jack.
Yeah, certainly, but Eastleigh won't care one bit. They've been the more effective side. Every time they've had the chance to cross to McCallum, they've not turned it down, and when the ball's been right, they've scored 2 goals from it, from free kick and one from open play on this right-hand side. Fantastic ball in. So, again, Ebbsfleet just not dealing with that threat, and he's very difficult to deal with, McCallum. He's so good in the air.
Maybe Ebbsfleet will be feeling a little bit hurt after that, after playing some nice football there. Sort of done by route one, as it were, as the header back by Chris Solly over halfway. Eastleigh now have just got to see out this half with the lead. Boldervine. Now at Angana, right of the centre circle to Rendell. Clements will pick it up against O'Neill on halfway. Clements slips, still has the ball sort of tucked underneath his body, but O'Neill eventually lets that go out of play and wins a throw. How can Ebbsfleet respond inside the final 3 minutes of normal time? Up towards halfway, McCallum picks it onto his right. Quigley didn't read that. And that's a poor pull backwards by Domi. Quigley's in a bit of a foot race with the goalkeeper. It's going to go back to Cousins. He spreads it out towards that far side, well collected, after a bit of a nervy moment at the back for Ebbsfleet, as that's a fairly powerful ball back to Mark Cousins, and he does well to get the ball out of his feet to his left edge of the box. Here comes Hollis, and that's a poor touch from him, scooped away by Atangana into Quigley, edge of the penalty area. Can he get away from his man? He can't. Domi comes across well and sort of revives that, and Ebbsfleet, after, well, just playing with fire at the back themselves, very uncharacteristic. They now have it under control somewhat in the middle. Hayden White out towards that right side to O'Neill, into Chris Solly on halfway towards the centre circle. Left of centre now is Hollis. Eastleigh just getting their shape ready as Solly hits a lovely pass out towards that right side. A lot of dip on that. McQueen gets the ball down the right side of the penalty area, up against two men. Back to O'Neill, corner of the box. Still got McQueen for company. Tries to turn away. Has to go back to right, 30 yards from goal. Down the right channel once more with McQueen, who gave Ebbsfleet the lead. O'Neill back to McQueen. In the box, low shot. Saved well by the feet of McDonald and well held up by Wabwoke, who turned away from his man and got his body in between the man and the ball, as McCallum tries a crossfield pass in search of Scott Quigley, who's up against Hollis. Quigley wins it, edge of the box, does well, onto his left foot. Quigley shoots over the bar. Lovely end-to-end move there by Eastleigh. Really well held up by Scott Quigley. Got the ball out of his feet on just inside the box, left foot it, but got his foot far too much underneath the ball. And it remains 2-1 to Eastleigh.
Yeah, half chance that for Quigley, wasn't it? Just managed to spin in behind Hollis, I think it was, the absolute defender, and then got himself into all sorts of trouble, Hollis, and then quickly couldn't capitalise though on a awkward bouncing ball. First touch was good, set himself up, but then blazed it over the bar, and he's still shaking his head after he missed that chance.
Ball in possession with Joe McDonnell. We're into the final minute of normal time here at the Silver Lake in the first half. Eastleigh lead 2-1 live on BBC Radio Solent. Nice flick by Maguire. It doesn't really go to anyone, but he did well to actually just win that physical battle in the middle, as Ebbsfleet with McQueen on halfway gets bundled over, wins himself a free kick. He's very good at winning those. Gets his body back into the defender and then just hitting the deck as soon as he feels some kind of touch. As it's Nigel Atangana who's down in the centre of the pitch. And it looks like we are going to need the physio to come on. But I have to say, Atangana didn't start the half particularly well. Struggled to trap the ball, get it under control. But since then, he sort of collected himself and been more involved in Eastleigh attacks as the half has gone on. As it looks like, is it a substitution? For a minute I thought it was going to be 8 minutes of added time, but it's actually Jake Taylor who's returning from injury.
Yeah, it's a shame, isn't it? Because just as you were saying, Tom, Atangana's improved a lot in this first half, and looks like Eastleigh going to be forced into a change right on the stroke of half time as Jake Taylor, number 8, comes on into midfield. Hopefully it won't disrupt the flow that Eastleigh have built up in this end of the first half.
Well, we are going to have 4 minutes of added time at the end of this first half. I do feel sorry for Nigel Atangana, very much displaced by Jake Taylor. And since Taylor's been injured, he started the last four. And I have to say, he's done fairly well in all of them. And although he's had a bit of a, you know, a nervy first sort of 15, he's really come into the game. And he'll be really disappointed that he'll have to go off after sort of trying to win his place back in the side. And he's done that well over the last few matches.
Yeah, he's certainly thrown his hat into the ring for sure. Done a fantastic job in the last four games. Obviously Jake Taylor, though, experienced player, coming back into the side now, and fantastic substitution if you are going to bring someone on to have him back in the side. But Atangana can be pleased with how he finished the first half, not necessarily how he started it.
No, that was a bit of a start to forget, but at the moment Eastleigh lead by 2-1 as Jake Taylor, the number 8, replaces him, the former Exeter, Stevenage and Reading midfielder. Got his first goal for the club in that 2-1 win at Fylde just a few weeks ago to get this run of wins going. Ball currently out of play on that far side for Spitfire's throw, just inside their own half. As we've got about 3.5 minutes left of extra time, plus whatever they deem to add on. And the win against Kidderminster the other day, the extra time just seemed to go on and on and on. We didn't quite, every time you thought that was it, referee decided, no, we're going to have a bit more. Thrown down the right, header forward by Eastleigh with McQueen as a first-time sort of volleyball forward by O'Neill is far too powerful for the run of David Amu. And Joe McDonald will gather that one. If you've only just joined us, Eastleigh leading 2-1, coming from behind yet again in the National League. Darren McQueen opening the scoring inside the first sort of 6 minutes with a lovely left-footed ball. Left-footed shot into the bottom right-hand corner. But since then, it's that man, Paul McCallum, 2 goals again after 2 goals at the weekend. First one, well, a stooping header. The second one, you're going to have to watch back because, I'd say the goalkeeper, Mark Cousins, did well as a fish looking like a salmon in his all-pink, floundering there as he tried to keep the ball out. Ebbsfleet trying to work it down the right-hand side, but Eastleigh have it once more in possession as there's a bit of a push in the back. The referee, James Durkin, says no, he's not having that. Spitfires have it over on that far side, a bit congested, and McCallum with the crossfield pass, trying to find Quigley. If the defender doesn't read that, he would have been in, but Hollis does well, and the ball forward by Domi takes a touch off an Eastleigh man and deflects nicely to Franchellette. He tries to bring it down the right-hand side, but across comes Hayden White. He's just throwing his arms up there in frustration. No options. Ebbsfleet will certainly feel hard done by that they don't have anything in this game so far. Certainly for being behind. They played the better football of the two sides, but at the end of the day, it's the only stat that counts as the one on the scoreboard, which Eastleigh currently lead 2-1. Quigley tries to get on the header from McCallum down the right-hand side. Takes a touch off an Ebbsfleet defender, and it will be an Eastleigh throw down by the corner flag away to my right. About 1.5 minutes of added time to go. Live on BBC Radio Solent. Eastleigh have the ball in the right end of the pitch. Are they going to look to get themselves a 2-goal cushion, or are they just going to be happy to get into the break? Almost a shape for a long throw there by Trent Boldevine. He does go into the penalty area, and that's fairly poor, doesn't beat the first man. Bit of a coming together on the edge of the box. Jake Taylor with his first chuck to the ball. Maguire, right of centre, ball into the box. Backstick towards McCallum, he goes down. Cries of a penalty, no, says James Durkin. He's yet to give a penalty this season. He certainly wasn't going to give one then.
Yeah, I think it was O'Neill for Ebbsfleet pulling the shirt. Well, at least McCallum thinks he's pulling his shirt. from the cross in. I think O'Neill can count himself a lucky man there, because again, similar to the second goal, Tom, McCallum pulled off at the back post, and then I think O'Neill thought he was going to get the better of him and then pulled him to the floor. But again, it seems to be McCallum just left on his own to scream his protest at the referee.
Ebbsfleet maybe fortunate there, as the ball out from the back gets a touch off McCallum. He tries to receive the ball in the edge of the box, and there is a foul on that right, on that left side, in line with the left corner of the box, and Eastleigh will have a chance just in the final, well, time is pretty much up here in the first half, but they do have an opportunity to get the ball into the box and perhaps add a third. It's probably a couple of yards from the left corner of the penalty area, away to my right, the silver eight, and it's going to be that man, Scott Chris Maguire, over this once more. And Jack, I think we know exactly which player he's going to be aiming for.
Yeah, again, Tom, he's licking his lips, isn't he? He's the coolest man on the pitch at the moment, McCallum. He's just starting offside, and it's a common theme for him, although he's just been booked, possibly for his protest earlier for the penalty.
He's got to be careful there, Paul McCallum, as he just sort of chased the referee out of the box there.
And he's still going. He's still going.
He's got to zip it, Paul McCallum, or he's going to get himself in trouble and ruin what's been a good night so far. Maguire into the penalty area, headed up by Hayden White towards the edge of the box. Taylor brings it down, gets away from his man onto his left foot. And that will be the final action of this first half here at the Silver Lake. Eastleigh lead by 2-1, coming from behind after Darren McQueen had put the Fleet into the lead inside the first 6 minutes of the game. A lovely left-footed low shot after a good work down the left-hand side by Domi and Ben Chapman. But since then, it's been the Paul McCallum show, Jack. 2 goals. And, almost getting himself a red card there for dissent.
Well, he's still going at the referee even now. He wants the penalty. But as you said, Tom, he's been classed this first half. Quite rightly got his 2 goals. 2 chances from Eastleigh. It's 2 crosses. One from a set piece just right at the 18-yard box, and another from a cross in a similar area from open play. And again, he's just so good in the air. First goal, front post, flick-on header, and the second goal. It's a bit more classic McCallum pinning off to the back post and heading it downwards. But again, Eastleigh might not have played the better football, but they find themselves in the lead at half-time.
But Ebbsfleet's certainly going to pose a danger in the second half. We almost mocked them at the beginning of the game, saying they're not playing with an out-and-out striker. But that's actually worked to their benefit, because McQueen and Amu just keep on switching up, don't they? You're not quite sure where they're popping up. And Ben Chapman as well, he's been really difficult to mark. First he's down the left-hand side, then he's over on the right-hand side. And I think that really, Eastleigh really struggled with that. It's certainly in the opening 20 minutes or so.
Yeah, they really did. And I think it was all Ebbsfleet. They had the momentum, as you say, 20 minutes, and they got the confidence from the McQueen goal early on in the game. But since Eastleigh equalised, Ebbsfleet haven't really got going again, and it's almost not their confidence a little bit, because they've not really found themselves too often inside the Eastleigh half towards the end of the first half. So again, Ebbsfleet will want to get back to how they started the game, and find those intricate passes, like you say, Tom, pulling about the Eastleigh defenders and finding that space to exploit.
Thank you very much, Jack. So that's it, half-time at the Silver Lake Stadium, with Eastleigh leading by 2-1. Eastleigh fans, get your thoughts into Jordan Clark back at BBC Radio Solent Studios. 0808 100 3800 is the number to call. Text 81333, start your message with the word Solent. And of course on Twitter, well, X as it's now called, it's at Solent Sport.
BBC Radio Solent Sport.
BBC Radio Solent Sport coming to you live from Fratton Park this evening, just coming up to 20:09. A reminder, we'll stay on the air tonight through until 10:30, then Paul Miller will be on the air at the slightly later time as we bring you reaction from all three of our commentary games tonight, from the Championship down to the National League. We'll bring you that interview with Steve Bone in a moment on the complete history of Portsmouth Football Club, marking their 125th anniversary this season. Before we do that, let's just head back to our studio in Southampton, where Millie Payne can bring you the half-time scores from elsewhere.
Thank you, Jordan. So we start off in the Premier League. Currently it is Luton 0, Burnley 1. And then moving down to the Championship, it is at half-time, Birmingham 2, Huddersfield 0. And it is Ipswich are also 2-0 up against Hull. It is 0-0 at half-time between Middlesbrough and Cardiff. It's also Plymouth 0, Millwall 0. It is 35 minutes in. It is Stoke 0, Southampton 0, West Brom 1, Sheffield Wednesday 0. And moving on to League One, it's also goalless at half-time between Blackpool and Derby. It is Bolton 1, Stevenage 1. Bristol Rovers are 2-0 up at Port Vale. It is Burton 0, Wigan 1. Cambridge 0, Barnsley 2. It is 0-0 between Carlisle and Peterborough. It is a goal apiece at half-time between Charlton and Exeter. It's Cheltenham 0, Fleetwood 1. Leighton Orient 1, Lincoln City 0. Northampton 2, Reading 0. Oxford 1, Shrewsbury 0. And as we know, it is Portsmouth 0, Wickham 1. And moving on to League 2, it is Crewe Alexandra 1, Gillingham 0. Doncaster and Crawley have the same scoreline as well as Grimsby and Barrow. It's Harrogate 0, Wimbledon 1. It's 0-0 between Mansfield and Wrexham. It's 0-0 also between Morecambe and Accrington. It's Newport 1, Colchester 1. Notts County are 3-0 up against Swindon. Stockport 2, Forest Green 0. It's goalless between Sutton United and Salford at half-time. It's Tranmere 1, Bradford 0. And at Walsall, it is currently 0-0 between them and MK Dons. And in the National League, we also have half-time scores for you there. It is Altrincham 1, Aldershot 0. Barnet 0, Flyde 1. Chesterfield 0, Bromley 0. Dagenred 0, York 0. Dorking 0, Kidderminster 1. And as we know, Eastleigh are 2-1 up at half-time against Ebbsfleet. It is goalless between Gateshead and Wealdstone. Oldham are 1-0 up at home to Maidenhead United. It is goalless between Solihull Moors and Rochdale. Southend are 2-0 up against Oxford City. And Woking are 1-0 up against Halifax. Thanks, Jordan.
Great stuff, Millie. Thank you very much. Solent Sport on your Tuesday evening, just gone 22-9. We're live from Fratton Park. Pompey a goal down at half-time at home to Wickham Wanderers. Andy Moon, Guy Whittingham will have your second-half commentary as soon as the players are back out from the dressing room. Right, let's give you another chance now to hear an interview that we did earlier on this evening. It's a big year for Portsmouth, their 125th anniversary year. There's lots going on around the club to mark the occasion. Of course, we were here at Fratton Park a couple of weeks ago for Pompey's last home game, where they unveiled the statue of Jimmy Dickinson outside the ground in the north stand between the north stand and the Fratton end. A quite brilliant statue and a really nice ceremony as well to unveil that statue for the first time. If you haven't seen it yet, well worth coming down to take a good look at it. There are plenty of bad football statues, aren't there? This one, certainly not in that bracket. It's been brilliantly put together. And around the statue as well, there's lots of information about Jimmy Dickinson and the career and his history as well that you can take in as you come and view the statue. And as well as that, there's been a new book launched as well, The Complete History of Portsmouth Football Club. And earlier on in the press box here at Fratton Park, one of the authors, one of the writers of the book, Steve Bone, came and joined us to tell us all about it.
It's difficult because there have, as you say, there have been so many highs and you know, almost as many lows with Pompey. You know, they've been to the very top and they've been very close to the bottom. I think for me the most enjoyable part of writing my section was writing about the sort of early to mid 80s when Pompey got promoted three times in 7 years, promoted from Division 4 in 1980, from 3 in 83, and then from 2 to the old Division 1 in 1987, and just the whole sort of journey throughout those years. People that were here, you know, there's many fans today that were here then that remember those times under Alan Ball and Frank Burrows and Bobby Campbell, people like that. For me, that was great just to sort of go over that again. I was able to write some of that section from memory because the memories are still so vivid of particular games and particular players. You know, I had the downsides as well because a lot of the 90s and late 80s weren't so good for Pompey, and the 70s were quite grim as well, in fact, before that rise. I think each of the five chapters tell similar stories of great times of triumph and pretty awful gloomy times in between. You know, any football club has those, but it does seem that Pompey have had more highs and lows than most.
Can you give me a little insight into where you started as well? You're a journalist anyway, I'm right in saying?
You're a
writer, but writing a book is a completely different skill. Where did you start?
Yeah.
How long did it take? Give us a little insight into the process of delivering something like this.
Yeah, a whole new ball game for me, because I'm a newspaper journalist and newspapers are all I've ever written for, magazines as well to an extent. So I'm used to being given a story to write, interviewing one person for it, writing 500 words, and then that's it. I can forget about it. This was 20,000 words. I had about a year to do it from the time I was given to do it.
And like going back to university.
Well, I didn't actually go to university, funnily enough, so it probably would have been if I had. But yeah, totally different. So I tried to do it in stages because I knew that I'd watched Pompey for 20 years of the section I was writing about, there was a certain amount in here in my head. But I knew I needed to research that section and particularly the years before I started watching as a fan.
On the latest edition of Stereo Underground from the BBC, we've got gig stories, requests and alternative anthems like these.
Hit me with your rhythm stick. Hit me. Hit me.
Every Wednesday night at 8 on BBC Radio Solent, or any time you want by going to BBC Sounds and searching for Stereo Underground.
And don't forget, if you search for Portsmouth on BBC Sounds, you will get our dedicated Portsmouth page, which is always well furnished by Andy Moon. You get the best bits of all of our Pompey interviews, and of course Moon's Musings goes up on BBC Sounds as well weekly, where you can subscribe as well so that you get a notification on the app to tell you exactly when a new episode has been uploaded. Just search for Portsmouth on the BBC Sounds app. Before that, we heard our interview with Steve Bone from earlier on this evening. If you want to listen to that in full, you can also go back and listen to the first hour of the show. He was on around about 6:30 tonight. We spoke for a good 8-10 minutes about the new book that he's been involved with, the complete history, all 125 years of it, of Portsmouth Football Club. They have only made 1,898 copies of that book. Already 1,000 were sold before they'd even sent it off to the printers by people who had subscribed in advance and were that desperate for it. I think of the around 800 remaining, 200 of those have already been snapped up by pre-orders. Still plenty, though, if you want to get your hands on one yourself as well. Steve was telling us about where you can do that. Of course, one of the main places, the Pompey store on Anson Road, just outside the grounds here. And Portsmouth City Museum as well, Museum Road, also stocking copies of the book as well. So you can get your hands on a bit of history, get it on your bookshelf at home. Well worth a read, a brilliant insight into the club's history by some excellent writers as well, the likes of Neil Allen, also involved from the Portsmouth News. Right, Solent Sport, just coming up to 12 minutes to 9. The players are back out on the pitch here at Fratton Park for the second half. They'll be back out the Silver Lake Stadium as well. So let's take you there now. First of all, Eastleigh against Ebbsfleet. Your second half commentary on BBC Sounds and the smart speaker comes from Jack Smith and Tom Murray.
Yeah.
Hi, Rob. Can you hear me? Or Millie. Welcome back to the Silver Lake Stadium. Eastleigh 2-1 up at half time against Ebbsfleet United. The players now back out onto the pitch. I'm joined by former Spitfires defender Jack Smith. I think we're definitely going to see an Ebbsfleet retaliation in the second half.
Yeah, I would have thought so, Tom. Obviously, the way they started the first half, they'd be hoping to replicate that same start in the second half, because the way they moved it around in the first 10 minutes was excellent. Little combination play, little one touches, dragging Eastleigh around the pitch and creating lots of space to exploit. But again, I think that first goal, tweaking at half time, Tom, for Eastleigh, just knocked the stuffing out of Ebbsfleet of that a bit and killed the momentum for them, because up until then they were moving the ball really well. But since that first goal went in for Eastleigh, Ebbsfleet have just dropped off a little bit.
Two goals from Paul McCallum, currently got four in his last, well, one and a half matches so far. Wouldn't be, well, it's actually what's going to happen next for him. Is it going to be a red card or a hat-trick?
Well, for East fans hoping for a hat-trick, I'm sure. Just a little bit put off here by the officials. They're talking to both managers, both Richard Hill and the FC manager. Not sure what about, Tom, but...
Yeah, there's a bit of a coming together just down there. Nothing physical. No, I mean, nothing being thrown. It's all verbal at the moment, but the referee, James Durkin, just having a... maybe it's still that ongoing penalty shout towards the end of the first half. That's the only thing I can possibly think of. Jason Bristow has just come over towards this near side. Richard Hill's still deep in discussion.
I'm not sure what it is, but it's putting a stop to this. It's the referee starting the second half. Just want to see the game kicking off again, Tom.
Yeah, I just want to see some football played. I mean, I can bring you scores elsewhere at the moment. Southampton at half-time have gone 1-0 up against Stoke. Stuart Armstrong with a sublime free kick. I've seen it. Jack, you've seen it. It's a bit of a peach, that one.
Oh, it is, isn't it? I mean, Ward-Prowse would be proud of that, you would have thought. Stuart Armstrong, it's good to see him back in the side as well. It's been a bit hit and miss in terms of managers dropping him in the side and then taking him out quite regularly, so good for his confidence.
Well, there was a few ironic cheers just a few moments ago.
Coming from us too, as well, I think.
We just want the half to start. Well, the conversation is finished between Richard Hill and James Durkin, and the linesmen have now gone to either side. And I think we're actually going to have some football now, Jack. So it's currently in the middle with Oos Cisse. And he's going to be getting us underway as Ebbsfleet will be shooting from left to right in this second half. They trail by 2-1, 2 goals from Paul McCallum. And eventually James Durkin is going to blow his whistle on the very mild October evening. Haven't even had to wear a coat this evening. It's been absolutely glorious. Not sure I was be just in a jeans and a hoodie this time of the year. It's lovely. And already, as you can probably hear, a free kick has been given down the left hand, down the right hand side after pushing the back. And Ebbsfleet, within the first minute of the second half, have got themselves a chance to whip the ball into the box.
Yeah, and a booking for the East defender as well. I think it's Rendell with the yellow card there. Didn't need to do it. I mean, Sweet Man wasn't going anywhere out on this right-hand side and just dragging to the floor. Clear and obvious yellow card, and also a dangerous chance here for Ebbsfleet to get a good ball into the box.
Josh Wright over this one. He's played every single minute so far this season. The experienced central midfielder. Everyone back for Eastleigh in their own penalty area. Chris Maguire forming a one-man wall on this near side. In comes the ball, lofted towards the back stick, headed up in the air, headed towards the edge of the box by Clement. Ebbsfleet still have it in possession, and Chapman has to go all the way back to halfway as Eastleigh try and get themselves out. Chapman now, diagonal ball over towards the left corner of the box, headed into the area, but then hits the head of Boldevine, who then just sort of slices it down the right side, and it's going to be picked up on the far side by Chris Solly. Ebbsfleet starting the second half with the ball at their feet. And finally, much to my pleasure, the scoreboard clock is now working for the second half. Took about a minute to get underway there. I've got a timer of my own, but it's always nice just to beat belt and braces with this kind of thing. 47 minutes gone, live on BBC Radio Solent, online on your smart speaker and the BBC Sounds app. Maguire in the heart of Eastleigh play, down the right-hand side, and the ball in central towards Boldevine is cut out, and Josh Wright will now have it. Just shy of the centre circle, Solly turns away from his man, plays it out towards the left channel on halfway. Domi forward, and across comes Langston Well and nips the ball off the foot of David Amu. And McDonald hoops it up towards halfway, and the ball forward by Ebbsfleet is collected on the chest by Francioletta. Boldevine lofts it down the right side, and Sacha Quigley in the touch from the defender feeds straight into the mouth of Quigley, as it were. And he's done well to hold the ball up on that far side and win himself a corner from, well, really a very... It didn't really look like a dangerous position, but he's managed to win inside a set piece on that far side.
It's not the first time he's done it either, Tom. He's just worked the channel, blind side of the defender, run the blind side of him, and again, just get a corner or get a foul. And he's done well quickly without really impacting the game. He's managed to draw fouls and get Eastleigh up the pitch.
Chris Maguire over this. The Scot, left arm goes up. Ball into the penalty area. It's really congested. Comes towards the edge of the box as Ebbsfleet try and get it away. Back to Taylor, who came on in the first half with the injury to Nigel Atangana. Otherwise, it's unchanged from the win against Ebbsfleet. There's the header forward up into the air in the penalty area. The ball goes out of play on that far side. It'll be another corner. Nice, positive, strong start from Eastleigh inside the first 3.5 minutes of the second half at the Silver Lake.
Again, just ramping up the momentum now, Eastleigh. Another corner, another set piece. Chance for McCallum to get on the end of it and get his hat-trick. Again, two headers in this game.
You'd feel a third goal for Eastleigh would really kill this one off. Ebbsfleet certainly, their heads hung as the second one went in after taking an early lead. Now to be trailing after that, as that's just a little word that James Durkin wants to have in the centre. I think it's between Quigley and one of the central defenders on the goal line. Mark Cousins getting in the action there as well. Now it looks like we are going to have this corner out on the far side. Second and quick succession for the Spitfires. Maguire over this. Taylor lurking on the edge of the box. Maguire in towards the penalty spot, headed towards the edge of the penalty area where it's picked up by McQueen, who tries to hit it first time out to the left, and Maguire comes well to win that back on halfway, although he's bundled to the floor. And the industrious Chapman, who never seems to stop running, cut across the Scot there and hits the ball out of play for a Spitfires throw, but just cutting out any potential counter-attack there. I have to say, Ben Chapman, he's been all over the place and in a good way.
Yeah, it's fantastic energy, isn't it? Just not just off the ball, but on the ball as well. Find those little pockets between the defence and midfield of Eastleigh and picking the ball up, creating chances, bringing players into play. Done really well, Ben Chapman.
Only 24 years old, the Gillingham Academy graduate, as Taylor is fed by McCallum down the right side of the penalty area. Challenge comes in. It's up by that corner flag and it goes out of play for an Ebbsfleet goal kick. But nice little work there by Paul McCallum, dragging his defender out wide before slipping it into Taylor. 5 minutes gone of the second half. Eastleigh lead 2-1. Both goals by Paul McCallum. O'Neill, first real touch of the ball in the second half, lofts it down the right side to McQueen, who collects it well. And he's got a lot of pace, but ends up having too much and runs it out of play for an Eastleigh throw on this near side.
Mentioned it at first half, Tom, but a really quick pitch, isn't it? The ball's zipping around the place and the groundsman's done a fantastic job here. It's a real carpet.
Yeah, it's looking really lovely, like a snooker table at the moment, as Langston left-footed ball up towards McCallum, bounces over him, across comes Maguire, he doesn't collect it, and Josh Wright will head it safely back towards former Spitfire Usise. Now in the centre circle with Domi, who picked up a yellow card after just a few minutes. Plays a lovely ball out to O'Neill on this right side. He gets himself into a crossing position, but actually takes a touch in field too much, and Clements wins that back. Now here comes Solomon Mwabwoke over halfway. To his right is Maguire. He's racing towards the edge of the box. He's got McCallum to his right. Feeds it to Quigley into the box. Touches away from Cousins. Curls it into the top corner. That is 3-1. And you'd have to say, with 6 minutes gone in the second half, that might just be that for the Spitfires. It's Scott Quigley. It's 3-1.
Yeah, fantastic play that. Fantastic finish from Quigley. But the build-up play from Chris Maguire, picking the ball up just shy of the 18-yard box. A lovely little reverse pass into Quigley. And then Quigley showing his strikers into there. Didn't take the shot first time. Cut inside, sat the defenders down. And then what a finish. Top right-hand corner. Goalkeeper left with no chance. 3-1 Eastleigh.
Ridiculous composure, I have to say. And you know, just to... In a position, there are so many strikers who have maybe fluffed their chances from there, maybe get a little bit nervous, not sure if they want to hit it with their left or their right. And he decided that he was just going to sit the goalkeeper and the defender down and then just caress it into the top corner. It's a lovely goal by Scott Quigley, and that is his fourth of the season. Got two against Oxford City just a couple of weeks ago. He likes the scoring at the Silver Lake, the former Stockport striker.
It's fantastic confidence as well, because in the first half, he had a similar opportunity from a similar area, just shy of the penalty spot, and he blazed it over the bar. But this time, again, not discouraged from that, just chopped inside, as you'd say, Tom, and sat the defenders down, and then took his time to place the ball into the top right-hand corner with the side of his foot. Lovely finish from Quigley there.
All came from Bailey Clements reading the cutback from O'Neill really well and then getting the ball out with pace as Langston picks it up just out the centre circle. Oh, and the ball just is a little bit too heavy for Chris Maguire. Otherwise, McCallum may have been in down the right-hand side. Lovely that feet there by Nwabwoke into the middle to Chris Maguire. Eastleigh now does a lot of confidence in their play. Spreads it out towards the right side to Boldevine. Can he take on his man? He runs forward towards the edge of the box, down the right-hand side, away from Domi, towards the byline. Can he get a cross in? He just runs the ball out of play, and it will be a goal kick. But that third goal has just calmed Eastleigh down. It's the perfect start to the second half. Ebbsfleet would have wanted to come out. They thought maybe we'd have to weather a storm, but at the moment they've only gone down the other end, and you'd think, touch wood, that they may have put the game beyond reasonable doubt. But it's going to take quite a comeback from Ebbsfleet.
Haven't really got going, have they, Tom, in this first half at all? And I said you'd expect.
There's a touch through the middle and it's a little bit too heavy. McDonald comes out, reads the situation well, gets a thumbs up from Bailey Clements over on this left and hits it out of play on this near side for an Ebbsfleet throw just in front of Richard Hill, who I think has finished his conversation now with the referee after that delayed start to the second half. Quigley, there's an extra spring in his step as he tries to start the press. Domi in the left wing back position on halfway. Switches it towards this near side. Chest of O'Neill picks it up. Does he have options to aim for? Plays it down the right side of the penalty area to McQueen. Cuts back on his left foot. Now in the middle of the Eastleigh half, right of centre, they will recycle possession. Nice ball by Solly to his left, and Cisse will get it over towards that far side. Now Domi up against his man. Feeds it to Cisse down the left side of the penalty area. Gets away from one challenge, but doesn't get away from that one. And Eastleigh will have it in possession with Quigley up towards halfway. Hits the ball off the defender, and that's the third ball to go out of play. And I think the kit man is probably down to his last one.
Yeah, he's losing his temper. I know him well as well. Eastleigh kit man, Jamie Cousins, does a bit of coaching on the scholarship here, scholarship programme at Eastleigh, and had the pleasure of working with him.
Tell you what, one of the ball boys has got to be situated over on that far side at the moment. They're going to be kept busy tonight, that's for sure. 10 minutes gone in the second half. 3-1 Eastleigh lead, live on BBC Radio Solent. Ebbsfleet just haven't quite got going so far in the second half as Maguire picks it up on halfway. Boldevine tries to get away from his man on that far side. And could that be ball four? It is out of play. And the kit man just... At this rate, he's actually going to have to make the balls himself.
So if it doesn't come to that, Tom.
Tell you what, I've I was going down past Sports Direct the other day. I thought of maybe I've just collected a couple of those out of the bin just to keep this game going.
I think there might be a few happy customers in Charlton's Ford at the moment as well. They might have had a few in their garden.
That's for sure. Ball forward by White is too heavy, and David Amu's not going to get that ahead of Joe McDonnell. And you just feel a bit of that. The wind has definitely gone out of Ebbsfleet's sails at the moment. They would have had set up themselves to get back into this game, maybe just to see if they can get themselves an equaliser early on. But they've got the mountain that they've got to climb in the second half has only got higher as the minutes have ticked by. It's a lovely finish by Quigley, who might just be in down the right-hand side, but the header just evades him. On the left is Domi, the Albanian, gets away from one challenge, into the middle. And Josh Wright picks it up away from the attention of Solomon Nwabwoke. O'Neill on this near side, up towards McQueen in the centre circle, gets away from Rendell, back to Wright. Got O'Neill for company down the right channel if he wants him. Does have it. And it's dinked into the centre, and O'Neill keeps the move alive. Right, now back into the centre of the pitch with Cisse. Hollis making a run to his left in the centre-back, marauding towards the edge of the box. Left side, he's still going. Can he get a ball into the box? Takes a touch, quite heavy, towards the byline. Will he keep it in play? He does, away from Boldevine. He's going to have to do well to work a crossing position from that, but he's got Domi for company. In towards Cisse, left corner of the box. He turns away from his man, across the face of the box. Here comes Wright, a challenge from Maguire, stops him from shooting. O'Neill in towards the front post. And it's hit out of play for a throw on this near side, but that's the first time that Ebbsfleet have been able to get a few passes strung together, and they did it well. Throwing on this near side, O'Neill away from Maguire, wins a corner. And that's better from the Fleet.
Yeah, it's better, looking better, Tom, as they start to build a little bit of confidence after that attack. Sustained period of pressure in the EC half there, just a little bit patient, but again, where in the first 20 minutes of the first half they was really intent, doesn't look like they're playing with that kind of level of freedom they had in that early stages of the game. Just looking a little bit restrained at the moment, Ebbsfleet.
But a goal can change absolutely everything. It's not over just yet if they were to get one. Franklin Domi will take this left-footed in-swinging low towards the back front stick, headed up and over the bar. No problems for Joe McDonnell. The scoreline remains 3-1 as we tick over 58 minutes gone here at the Silver Lake. It's now starting to look convincing for Eastleigh. They've calmed themselves down. Touches aren't quite as loose, and I have to say, the person who's really got their tail up since that is Scott Quigley, and of course he's on a yellow card, so he doesn't want to get too excited so far.
No, and that's where obviously substitutes might come in as well. Tom, obviously you've got the likes of Rutherford there as well, can provide plenty of energy, and Charlie Carter as well to bring off from the bench. So again, Richard Hill might just take that into consideration and, you know, avoid any unwanted surprises.
Eastleigh did throw away a two-goal lead against Oxford City only a few weeks ago here at the Silver Lake. That was in the final sort of 15 minutes of the game, so he'll certainly have that in the back of his mind as McCallum tries to win it after Quigley was thrown to the floor. Almost inspiration taken from the Rugby World Cup there as Rendell picks it up in the centre circle. Lofted ball towards Clements, and that's almost a nice ball forward to Maguire, but it goes under the Scots foot, and Ebbsfleet will have it back in control with O'Neill. Left footed ball over the top, nicely almost brought down, and that touch from Chapman just let Langston, his eyes lit up there as Langston is just trying to get himself out of trouble, almost dangerous as the ball goes forward and collected by Hollis, left of the centre circle to the right. Solly lets it go through his legs, and O'Neill will pick it up in front of the technical area on this near side, just short of the hour mark here at the Silver Lake. 3-1 the Spitfires lead, so make it four wins in their last six games. Quite the turnaround after that 6-0 thrashing at home to Gateshead as Cousins tries to play it out from the back, and Quigley just didn't quite have the turn of pace to try and get that off White, who plays the ball down the right side, and across comes Rendell well, and a no-look pass back to McDonnell. His ball forward goes over the head of Wabwoke, and Rendell has it on the edge of his own box, and this looks like what could be a head injury in the centre of the pitch. Not quite sure who's gone down. It might be Chapman. It is. He is up. Wabwoke has come over and given him a pat on the back, so I think he'll be okay to continue. And that's good. Chapman, he's been superb so far in this game. Not quite got going in the second half, but a formidable first half performance certainly from the 24-year-old. There are options on the bench for Ebbsfleet. Craig Tanner, one of them, got one goal this season and a 4-1 win against York. A former Reading and Aldershot striker. They could also turn to Shaq Coulthurst, Tottenham Academy man. As the flick on by McCallum, Chris Maguire didn't read that, and they'll go through to the arms of Mark Cousins. Bowls it out quickly to his right, and that's almost a loose touch that was pounced on by McCallum, and they haven't got it out of danger yet. McCallum sort of frothing at the mouth, looking for a hat-trick. He really, really wants it. Ball forward, collected on the chest, and across comes Trent Rendell. Brings down Chapman, who seems to be in the wars at the moment. I have to say, Dennis Kertrude, the German Ebbsfleet manager, was quick off his seat there. You can certainly hear his cries from him. He's not happy with that one. And it is going to be a yellow card for Trent Rendell.
I think it was peeling for the elbow.
In a minute.
Sorry, Tom. I think it was peeling for the elbow there, the Ebbsfleet manager. And he's still going to the fourth official. And
I think, actually, what's going to happen here, because the yellow card has gone to, I think, an Ebbsfleet man. It might have been Chapman, but Trent Rendell is already on a yellow card, and he might have just escaped a second yellow there. The yellow card's been brandished, but I think that might be due to arguing.
There's a lot going on there in the dugout as well. Richard Hill coming over to the Ebbsfleet manager, exchange of words. Not sure what it was, but game's on the way now.
David Amu chasing what looks like a lost cause down the right side. Across comes Langston, gets his body in between the two well, and calmly just plays it back to his keeper and McDonald. Amu offering a bit of pressure. McDonald doesn't seem fazed, but the long ball is picked up in the middle by Josh Wright, who's weaving through players, and he might have just flicked it through to McQueen in the penalty area. McQueen, lovely save. Can the rebound go in the goal? No, it can't. Really good defending, but the move isn't dead yet. O'Neill on this right-hand side, up against two men. Back to Chapman on his left foot, right corner of the box. In towards Solly, down the right-hand side. O'Neill's got a bit of space, but quickly out comes Clements, but he turns away from O'Neill in the penalty area, onto his left foot, shoots, deflected, over onto that far side, headed towards the edge of the box, and Jake Taylor will just loft it over towards Boldewine on the far side, who can now bring it forward at pace. He tries to get away from Domi. He's still going, Boldewine. It's another amazing run from the Dutchman. And eventually, Ebbsfleet are able to get it back to their keeper, and that ball short out from the back has almost put themselves back in trouble. But Hayden Hollis, well, he's just given away a corner. Came off him last. He had no options to pass to, but I have to say, before we get to this corner on that far side, great save by Joe McDonald.
Yeah, it really was, Tom. Glad you picked up on it, because it was a one-on-one and it was such a crucial moment in the game. 62, 63 minutes into the second half, he's 3-1 up. And again, big save from Joe McDonald. Just when you want your goalkeeper to step up, absolutely haven't had many chances. And again, the second goal might have just lifted their spirits, and McDonald was there to parry it away. Really good from that Joe McDonald. Made himself nice and big.
Crawl on the far side. 64th minute here at the Silver Lake. Chris Maguire to take this one. In comes the ball. Up goes the headers. It goes out towards the edge of the box. Jake Taylor will pick it up about 30 yards out. Cries of shoot. Ends up getting the ball back into the penalty area. Lifted on towards the back post. And that's come off an Eastleigh man last. And it will go out for a goal kick. 3-1. Ebbsfleet get us going once more. Quickly, they need to find themselves a goal to get back in the game. Darren McQueen, who opened the scoring inside the first 6 minutes, almost getting that for the Fleet.
They're ribbing a bit though, haven't they, Tom, in terms of building up, playing out from the back. Used to be done with a purpose and tempo, and again they've given the ball away.
Lost the ball and in the penalty area is Quigley. Can he get a second? It's blocked. And Ebbsfleet, masters of their own downfall there almost. They managed to get out towards O'Neill on this near side. Low ball into the centre, picked up by Chapman. He's been in the wars recently, but he's picked himself up and dusted himself down. Hayden Hollis brings the ball over halfway, and the defender is about 30 yards out from goal, out towards Domi on the left side, up against Boldewine. Domi feeds it towards McQueen. He swap wings on that left side, tries to wriggle away from his man, plays it back. The ball is almost a little bit too short to Cisse, and Solly will pick it up central in the Eastleigh half. Reverse ball towards the edge of the box to Chapman. He tries to get away from his man. Left corner of the box, quick feet, trying to work his way into a shooting position or a cross. He does win himself a corner on that far side. Ebbsfleet there again, nice bit of possession, working the ball well, but they just couldn't quite get a final ball into the box.
It's better build-up play that, though, from FC. A little bit more patient and switching the play quite well, exploiting the gaps of Eastleigh, but Eastleigh have defended well so far in the second half as FC have a corner in this left-hand side.
Corner for FC on that far side. O'Neill has come short for it, but it looks like it's going to be a right-footed in-swinger. I think it's Josh Wright that's over this one. Everyone bar Maguire back in the Eastleigh penalty area. And they're now starting to crowd the six-yard box. This is obviously something off the training ground. Ball comes in, punched in a header by McDonald towards the edge of the box. McQueen gets it out towards Wright on that left-hand side. Feeds Chapman down the left channel, and Jake Taylor is not leaving him alone, and that's really good defending there by Jake Taylor. But Chapman does manage to turn, but doesn't quite get the ball out of his feet, and Jake Taylor eventually gets the ball. McConey comes as far as right across the face of the box. O'Neill tries to get the ball onto his left foot. Eastleigh might be able to get this away, but it bounces over towards this near side where Hollis will pick it up. He has to go back into his own half. Ball forward, flicked on, hits the thigh of Rendell, who slips, and down the right side of the penalty area is O'Neill. Looks to cut back, tries to get away from Clements, does, low ball into the penalty area, and again Taylor is there to mop up and hit it. No questions asked, it's out of play on this near side for an Ebbsfleet throw, as we're going to have a change here.
Substitution for Ebbsfleet United in the pitch for Josh Wright, being replaced by 18, Billy Clifford.
Billy Clifford coming on for Josh Wright, whose race is run. 30 years old, Billy Clifford, joined from having to Waterlooville back in January, another player that's got himself into the book quite a lot. 4 yellow cards so far this season.
There's been a few in this game as well, Tom. Haven't been counting, but must have been the 4s or 5s.
Certainly quite a few, but Eastleigh might have a chance if Mwoke can get the ball out of his feet just to break forward, and a few challenges flying in. The ball eventually does go out of play on this near side, and the referee just quickly in to stop any lashing out. He's had to do that a couple of times so far, and this game has got a bit of bite about it. Oh, and they've almost lost it in the middle there, Ebbsfleet, and they do in the centre of the pitch now with Langston getting onto that loose ball. The player's just hobbling in the middle, and maybe he's had his boot taken off, but Taylor has it for Eastleigh. Driving in towards the Ebbsfleet half, plays it towards his left, and Mwoke. Now Clements shapes to cross, fakes, edge of the penalty area, feeds it to Taylor. Can he get a ball reverse pass? It's blocked. Comes out towards this near side, Hayden White for company, pushes him in the back, and the referee says that's going to be an Ebbsfleet throw on this near side, and O'Neill is going to launch this forward. No, he's not. He cuts in, and it's quite dangerous, and Chapman isn't there quick enough. Edge of the box now is Quigley. Is he going to go for goal? Quigley with the low shot, and it's well gathered by Cousins, but Ebbsfleet getting themselves in danger as the ball is thrown central through the middle, and here comes Chapman quickly to get underway here. McQueen making a run down the right. He needs to stay onside. He does. Flies with flag, stays down. McQueen down the right-hand side, onto his left foot, gets away from one challenge. Chapman, 25 yards from goal, shapes to shoot. So it goes back to Cisse, right corner of the box. 30 yards out now is Solly, is absolutely back in numbers. 2 banks of 4. O'Neill exchanges passes on the right-hand side with Billy Clifford. He's getting his first real touch of the ball. No one really to aim for in the middle, and Chris Solly has to play it across the pitch over to Hollis on the left-hand side. He steps on the ball and plays it to his right in the middle of the Eastleigh half to Cisse. Clifford, 30 yards from goal, down the right. He feeds it to O'Neill into the penalty area. Chapman turns, lovely 360, drags his shot well wide. That's not going to trouble Joe McDonald. Goes into the near post side netting, but that was never, ever going to be a cause for concern. But what I have to say is, although that was Ebbsfleet an extended period of possession, they didn't know what to do with it because Eastleigh got back well and in numbers and defended well and gave them no space to get in behind.
Yeah, and that's been the theme of the second half, Tom. Despite Eastleigh getting a 2-goal advantage, they haven't sat back and they've pressed Ebbsfleet very well. And like you say, when they haven't been able to press, they've dropped back into a good shape and been really hard to break down. And for all of Ebbsfleet's good possession, it comes to the edge of the 18-yard box, and they've not found the real quality, not found the real opening to get through that back three of Eastleigh so far.
Rendell is clattered in the back on halfway. It'll be a free kick to the Spitfires. Now into the final 20 minutes of normal time. They lead 3-1. It's been a good performance since the opening 15 minutes or so, where they just didn't quite have control of the game. Langston He goes long over towards the right hand side. Comes off an Ebbsfleet head. Off Domi. And the Spitfires will have a throw in line with the edge of the box on that far side. Shooting from right to left in this half. Live commentary on BBC Radio Solent with myself and former Eastleigh defender Jack Smith alongside me. Quick feet down the right from Boldervine, but he eventually loses the ball. And Hollis will have this. Hits it up towards halfway in search of McQueen, but he's not ever winning that aerial duel with Langston. Ebbsfleet just trying to go for the short passing out the back once more as O'Neill, under pressure from Bailey Clements, wins the ball well. Does Clements, he's unbundled to the floor, and the referee says nothing, we play on. In the middle now with Chapman, almost digs a ball over the top, over the head of Rendell, who reads it well, and now McCallum to Maguire down this left-hand side, tries to play it over the top towards Bailey Clements, who's in a bit of a foot race with Clifford. Clements slips on the turf. It's not the first time we've seen that. A lot of water on the pitch. It's been really well dealt with. It's made for some slick football. Chapman gets away from the attention of Wawoke on towards that left-hand side as Ebbsfleet bring it over halfway. Domi into the middle again to Chapman, who's followed his original pass. Clifford just shy of the centre circle. To his right now to Solly. O'Neill in this right side plays it towards White, who'd made a run down that right channel. I have to say, for a centre-back, Hayden White certainly making a few marauding runs I've seen. You don't expect him to be there, and suddenly he just pops up.
That's very Chris Wilder would be proud, wouldn't it? Overlapping centre-backs.
No strikers and overlapping centre-backs at National League level. Billy Clifford. Quick one-touch football on this near side. O'Neill trying to get across into the box. Plays it low towards the edge of the box to Chapman, right of the D. Now with Clifford once more as Ebbsfleet are forced back. And Clifford has it very central in the Eastleigh half. Gets away from Chris Maguire, who looking a bit tired, just leaves him. 30 yards from goal, right of centre. Out towards this right channel. O'Neill feeds it. Back ball by Chapman. And he doesn't get it away from the hands of Joe McDonald, who just collects the ball, goes down to the grass and takes the sting out of that attack. It seems to be a bit predictable at the moment from Ebbsfleet. Everything's going through O'Neill and Chapman. If you can just stop the ball getting to either of those two, you stop the attack. Ebbsfleet, I don't know if you remember, they've talking of like weird ownership, as it were, back in 2007. Did you ever hear of the My Football Club?
No, I don't think so.
Well, basically, to fund the takeover, I'll just join in a minute as Jake Taylor stops that Ebbsfleet attack. And now this might be a chance for Eastleigh to break forward. Scott Quigley touches ahead of him, and Boldervine's made a run down the right. Back to Quigley, still got it down the right side. He's got options at the back post. McCallum for the hat trick! He gets his third of the evening. Quigley bursts down the right hand side. Lofted the ball towards the back post. There was only ever one man it was going to. Cousins was nowhere near it, and he just nonchalantly headed it black of face into the bottom left-hand corner. 4-1 they lead, 15 minutes ago. Paul McCallum gets his hat-trick.
Well, it's been a common theme of this whole game, Tom. Quigley making that darting channel run, blindsided the centre-back, gets out wide, crosses it to the back post, and who's there yet again? It's Paul McCallum for a well-deserved hat-trick. Outstanding from him. Every time it goes around him, certainly around his head, he looks like he's going to score. Just such good movement, such good placement of his header. Headed it down, leapt in the air, centre-half nowhere near him. I think that's job done now, we can say for Eastleigh.
4-1 they lead. McCallum's 10th goal of the season, his 5th. In the last two matches, he has struck that rich vein of form. And just before we actually get started, I'll continue that chat about the takeover. That goal very rudely interrupting me. My Football Club, they actually let fans buy a £35 stake in the club, and then they got to vote online on like decisions. It was quite a different at the time. It obviously didn't last, but a couple of my friends actually gone into that. And Eastleigh, they're going to burst forward once more. Maguire to shy of halfway into the middle to Taylor. It's a little bit short, but the diminutive midfielder manages to get away from Cisse, and that's nice play by Nwabwoke out towards the left side, and Franchelletta almost let run out under his foot. feeds it down the right channel. Here comes Boldevine, opts in the middle, Quigley at the front post. It's not low enough for him. Boldevine collects on his chest. A team to have handled that, and Ebbsfleet will get us back underway quickly as they try and search, well, for what would be a consolation goal at the moment. They trail by 4-1, and this would so far be, well, certainly the most convincing win of the season for Eastleigh. And I have to say, it's a performance, it's a win that's been coming. They've had a few matches where they haven't been able to put teams to the sword, get that third and fourth goal, but today it's all gone right for them.
Yeah, it has. Every shot Eastleigh have had seems to have gone in the back of the net, mainly thanks to that man Paul McCallum again. But Eastleigh have worked the wide areas well. Every time they've come with a game plan, they've got it into the channels, and then when they've been in those channels, whether it's Quigley, whether it's Maguire, they've just lofted the ball to the back post, and they know McCallum, even if it's not going to be on target, he's going to win the knockdown.
Long free kick forward. McCallum obviously the target. Cousins claims well, and O'Neill will bring it forward. Actually, not just a hat trick for Paul McCallum, a hat trick of headers for him.
I can get behind that. That's that's what we like
to
see.
That's exactly what you want to see. That definitely shows a team that instead of playing sort of a false nine and no strikers, just punt it up to the big man, get his noggin on it, boom, 4-1. And Eastleigh, to be honest, they look like they could go on and grab a fifth if the opportunity arose. They're not done yet, you feel. It looks like it's going to be two wins out of two for Richard Hill in his permanent manager so far after that win at Halifax. Eastleigh will be going in the right direction up the table as Clements is battered by O'Neill on this near side. Maybe went down a little bit too easily, but he's holding his right leg on this near touchline. The German manager of Ebbsfleet, Dennis Kurtry, looking emotionless down on the floor, sort of looming over him at the moment, just sort of thinking, get up, you're 4-1 up. There will be a free kick to the Spitfires on this near side. Mm-hmm. 4-1 they lead, and it's Maguire who will take this. Don't think he's going to launch this into the box, or maybe he will. Actually, he crosses it across the pitch, and Boldevine's just going to have to turn on the afterburners to get onto that, and he doesn't. And that's sloppy from Chris Maguire. Ebbsfleet will have it once more, going across their back line now is Billy Clifford, the second half substitute, trying to just get something going, something for maybe to make the last 12 minutes interesting. O'Neill once again playing that curved ball down the right hand side. Rendell wins that very easily, and Eastleigh just play it out from the back as Taylor just about collects it on the edge of his own box. And Maguire now down the left, and Clements is making the run, and O'Neill got a really good touch on that to take it away from him. But here comes Maguire collecting the loose ball down the left channel, skips away from his man. He's got Quigley in the box if he can find him. Right, so McCallum on the edge of the box, he can't quite get the ball out of his feet for goal number four, and the attack finishes there as Chapman will collect it on halfway for Ebbsfleet. Still wanting to come forward with the ball, and he tries to thread it through to McQueen, who made the run. And Maguire dinks it over the top. Will Quigley get onto this? Cousins comes out well and claims, and from the floor just throws it out immediately. No, he wants to have the least amount of time on the ball, as Mark Cousins, the former Colchester keeper.
Can't afford to, can he? 4-1 down. Ebbsfleet got to go for it now. Throw caution to the wind, but if you defend like they have done this second half, I can't see it be much of a miracle for Ebbsfleet fans.
They seem to be going for the same ball every time. O'Neill just down the right, and Rendell seems to be reading it, although they are trying down the left avenue, as it were, with McQueen, who swap wings, just to try something different. Solly now down the left-hand side. Can he get the ball? He can. Into the box, and moves lurking. Langston also there, headed out of play on that far side. He's done well, George Langston. I feel I haven't really had to mention him too much, and that's purely because he hasn't really put a foot wrong.
Yeah, and in fact, the centre-back trio for Eastleigh have done particularly well. They've been very solid in the second half. Every time the ball's got near the Eastleigh goal, they've been on hand to get in a block or position themselves to clear the ball well. Physically, very imposing three as well. Also, shout out to Rendell in that three. I think he's been very good, the young man. Covered well and used his strength and his power and his pace to win the individual battles in 1v1s.
Substitution for Ebbsfleet, Shaq Coulthurst coming on in place of David Amu, an actual out-and-out striker, former Tottenham Youth Academy graduate. Had a quite a fruitful spell at Barnet over the years, scoring 23 goals in just over 80 appearances. That's his best of the career. It's a ball forward for McCallum, and he's in a bit of a foot race here at the back there with White, who wins that one. You saw McCallum's eyes just light up. He thought maybe tonight was the night that he might beat someone for pace. Clifford turns in the middle and drives towards the Eastleigh box. And he's done really well, actually, here. And he gets it out towards this near side to O'Neill. Shaping his body up for the cross. Plays it back to Clifford in the middle. Skips away from his man. Down the right side of the box. It's well dealt with there by Trent Rendell. And on the left-hand side, Wabwoke doesn't really have options, but he manages to feed it to Quigley on halfway. He's got three men around him, bundled to the floor. He doesn't get the foul. Ebbsfleet will continue as Richard Hill just pulls him up. And Quigley's just got to be a bit careful on a yellow card not to throw the ball away. He doesn't want to ruin what has been a good evening.
It might be time for Richard Hill to consider making a few subs as well. A few fresh faces on, like you say. Don't want to take the risk of Quigley on a yellow card. Might be others in there for the in a blue shirt. Just need to be cautious of.
Next up for Eastleigh, they've got Hartlepool away, currently in eighth place in the National League, so you certainly want your best team available for that, and nothing stupid this evening. Handball there in the centre of the pitch. That's Clifford, the culprit. And Eastleigh will have a free kick just short of the centre circle. Dover Athletic coming up in the FA Cup fourth qualifying round. That's next weekend. An interesting tie, although Dover have seemed to be a bit of a bogey team over the years, but they're currently languishing towards the bottom of the National League South, so you think it's a really good opportunity to make the first round proper. And I know teams like to rotate and that, but Jack, for you, FA Cup, you want to be playing the strongest side every time.
Oh, every time. It's massive for players, isn't it? FA Cup, so prestigious competition you want to be in, particularly a non-league. You want a big draw, get through those early rounds. And I think for Eastleigh, not only players and fans, but fans, they're happy that it's a home draw against Dover.
Coulthurst gets his first touch and it's four. And Jake Taylor pounces on that, feeds it to Quigley down the right-hand side. Of course, he's got McCallum in the box. Quigley turning onto his left foot, curls it off the post. Oh, that would have been a wonderful fifth goal for Eastleigh. Wonderful work by Scott Quigley, but Ebbsfleet now bring it away up towards halfway. Down the left-hand side here, they're running forward the ball. Up against Francioletta, what can they work from here? It's Darren McQueen on in possession. Clifford. Stationary now, the move, it seems. Although the edge of the box, can they feed McQueen down the right side? Well intercepted again from Trent Rendell. Picked up by Chris Solly on the top of the centre circle. Out towards the right now to Hayden White. He's got Luke O'Neill for company in his usual spot down the right side. Plays a central pass. The ball is nicked off him in the centre by Jake Taylor. And here's Wabwoke. Tries to feed it through the legs towards Chris Maguire, but the deflection puts it back in Ebbsfleet possession. Oh, Scott Quigley. I mean, what a goal that would have been.
Oh, thoroughly deserved, wasn't it? We were praising his first goal for placing it in the top right-hand corner. He almost did exactly the same there, put for the crossbar. Picked it up there to the 18-yard box, curled it. Unfortunately, just hit the framework, but unfortunately there for Quigley, deserves a second goal.
That definitely would have been goal of the evening, that's for sure. Maybe goal of the month, maybe. O'Neill in possession on this right side. Can Ebbsfleet get themselves anything to get back in the game? Quick 1-2, but he's got men around him, and the ball towards the edge of the penalty area, almost swarmed by Jake Taylor, but they still have it. Clifford, he's running down a bit of a blind alleyway down the right, but he manages to win himself a corner, does he? He does. Off Bailey Clements there.
Just no presence inside the Eastleigh penalty box, though, is there, Tom? You know, it gets wide again to O'Neill, as we've said in commentary many a time, on this right-hand side, but there's opportunities to cross it, but just looking up, McQueen's not the biggest. There's not really a presence in the box to get the ball into.
Tell you what, I wish I got a pound for every time that I said O'Neill on the right, because I'd be a millionaire by now. Here comes the corner, left-footed from Domi towards the front post. McDonald can't quite claim that. Comes out towards this near side. Brilliant turn by Maguire. He's got Paul McCallum ahead of him, as well as the ball divine. Curls it over the top. Here comes Paul McCallum into the penalty area. Is he going to get his fourth? Oh, and it's wide. It hits the advertising hoarding behind the goal. Hits the back of the net from that side. The fans behind the goal thought that had gone in. Not to be for Paul McCallum for number four.
No, it wasn't. Wonderful work on this left-hand side by Maguire. Left-footed ball just out of reach of the Ebbsfleet defender into the path of McCallum. An
inside the 18-yard box. You would have thought McCallum would put that away, but not this time. And he quite rightly gets standing ovation, McCallum, as he comes off.
A well-deserved standing ovation there for Paul McCallum. A hat-trick this evening. And that was his final action of the night as we enter, I think it's the final, I'd say, few minutes of this second half. Substitution as well for Ebbsfleet in that time. Number 17 coming on for them. Toby Edzer, Nottingham Forest Youth Academy central midfielder. Ball over the top in search of Coulter. Langston just manages to arrest his fall. Gets the ball up towards halfway, and Clifford almost gets it through the legs. As we can hear the applause as Paul McCallum down the touchline. Well deserved, drinking that in. Not much going on the pitch at the moment as McDonald hits it up over halfway. Touchdown by Quigley, well towards Mwaboke. Quigley receives the ball back off his teammate. Now to Clements on this left-hand side. Taylor, just inside the Ebbsfleet half, has got to go backwards to Rendell. And that'll go all the way back to Joe McDonnell. If you were to pick a man of the match, what would you go for?
Oh, it's a tough one, isn't it?
Yeah, exactly. No prizes for guessing who.
McCallum all day long. Exceptional. Three headers as well. Gets a bonus point, I think.
Just a, well, it's just a complete performance from Eastleigh. This is aside, and also the reaction to going a goal down to win this one seemingly so convincingly now, and to also not have to play brilliantly.
Yeah, definitely. And I must admit, first 10 minutes or so, Tom, in the first half, I was a little bit concerned because Eastleigh found it really hard to get to grips with the shape of Ebbsfleet, and they were dragging them about. But since that equalising goal for Eastleigh, they've really turned it on, and they've punished Ebbsfleet.
First touch of the ball for Oscar Rutherford, up against his man down the right-hand side of the penalty area, very central, towards the edge of the box. Clements, first time ball down the left. Maguire cuts back onto his right foot. Chris Maguire still going towards the edge of the box. Mwaboke leaves it for Taylor. Back out on that left side to Rutherford. Ball into the box, header towards goal, and O'Neill will collect it at the back post, and I think the flag has gone up. Danger averted as we enter the final couple of minutes of normal time here at the Silver Lake, live on BBC Radio Solent. Eastleigh leading by 4-1.
Just toying with Ebbsfleet a little bit, weren't they there, Tom? Just in and around the 18-yard box, little one-touch passes. Really intricate, really patient. Again, I think Eastleigh looking more likely the two sides to score a fifth here.
Will there be another goal in this game? Billy Clifford bringing it forward, and he feeds a lovely ball through to McQueen in the penalty area, rolls it past Joe McDonnell, makes it 4-2. Lovely finish by Darren McQueen, who gets his second goal of the game, and that just, you know, tarnishes that scoreline a little bit for Eastleigh in what's been a great evening. 4-2.
Well, out of nothing really there, Tom, wasn't it? I mean, Eastleigh picked the ball up on the halfway line, and again, movement from McQueen, he's done that so often in this game. Little movement to come feet, and then spanning behind the back four of Eastleigh, and got on the end of it. Lovely weighted through ball, and good composure from McQueen there. Gets his second goal of the game, but interesting to see how much added time there could be here. Tom could be in for a good finish here.
Ebbsfleet have got their tails up, it seems. Can they get, I mean, if they were to get another one, especially with added time to come, who knows what would happen? And that'll certainly be in the back of the minds of the Eastleigh players, not to throw this one away. O'Neill down the right again. He's got a run down the right-hand side by Hayden White, the overlapping centre-back, into the middle. It goes behind McQueen. And now here's a chance for Eastleigh to break. The touch is heavy from Mwaboke on the edge of the box. Franchelletta just decides that he's going to hoof it up towards halfway, but O'Neill brings it down well, the ex-Burnley defender. First time ball by Clifford. Absolutely no one. And that's exactly what Eastleigh will want as it rolls out of play for a goal kick. And we should be having once the car park is open, please, the fourth official tell us how much added time it's going to be. Does it look like a... No, it's a five. Is he going to go for five? Originally it was seven. What's he going to pick, the fourth official?
And you're right with five. I don't think there's been many stoppages so far, Tom. No real injuries, thankfully.
The only real stoppage, really, was the coming together with the officials at the beginning of the game before we even got started. There it is, 5 minutes of added time for Eastleigh to see this one out. They lead by 4-2. Darren McQueen getting his second goal of the game there, just to add a little bit of bite towards the end of the game, as it's won down the right-hand side by Boldevine into the penalty area. He goes down, penalty! Well won by Enzio Boldevine. Chased the lost course down the right-hand side. Muzzled his way past the defender. Brought the ball down the byline into the penalty area towards the six-yard box. Hit the deck. And James Durkin had no hesitation at pointing to the spot. And just as Ebbsfleet get themselves a second, Eastleigh have themselves a chance to make it a brilliant five.
Well, as Boldevine created that out of nothing, didn't he? Just an aimless long ball. Ebbsfleet defender was shielding it out. Poor from him, really. Allowed Boldevine to get in inside the penalty yard, a penalty box, and then got the wrong side of him. You can't lay your hands on him. He did. And then no complaints. Penalty. And Maguire can put the cherry on the cake here.
Chris Maguire up against Mark Cousins. He scored a penalty against Halifax at the weekend. Two goals to his name so far, the ex-Sheffield Wednesday and Pompey man. He steps up, Maguire dispatches it. 5-2, lovely goal, sends Cousins the wrong way, and Eastleigh have five.
Yeah, well deserved this, Eastleigh. Since they're going a goal down in the first half, they thoroughly deserved this victory here tonight. Maguire with the icing on the cake with the penalty, well taken penalty. Corner, right hand corner of the goal, keeper dive to his left, no chance. 5-2 to Eastleigh, and all round very good night for the Spitfires.
You thought I jinxed it at the beginning of the game when I said no clean sheets for either side for so many matches. You were saying this has a 0-0 written all over it.
Well, I know, seven goals tonight and I think good finishes, it has to be said, all of them. Maguire there, fantastic penalty, never in doubt. Hard and low into the right hand corner, keeper left with no chance.
At least about 3 or 4 minutes left of the additional five that were given, especially with the stoppage they'd expect a little bit more. Could we be in for any more action? We shall see. Ebbsfleet have really had the stuffing knocked out of them after starting the game so well, but their poor form is looking to continue after that win against Boreham Wood at the weekend. They're back to losing ways and they're really getting thrashed at the moment here at the Silver Lake. It's a really good, solid performance by Eastleigh and a convincing win. Solly, who at the beginning of the game we said was being the catalyst, the conductor as it were, controlling the temper of the match, but since then really Eastleigh have, once they got that equaliser, they never looked back. O'Neill down the right side, ball into the penalty area, Rendell knocks it out at the front post. Back to O'Neill on this right side, towards the edge of the box. Clifford, 30 yards from goal, doesn't shape to shoot. In the penalty area, Coulthurst will fire it, it's blocked. And McDonald will dive on that at the foot of Billy Clifford. And now there's a bit of a barge, it's a red card! And it's Billy Clifford who's been sent his marching orders. He can't quite believe it. Has he left his foot in there on Joe McDonald, potentially?
I think he left his foot on Langston or perhaps Rendell. Really silly from Clifford, though. Game's done, just get in, deal with the defeat, but suspended for 3 games, really silly.
Already picked up 4 yellows so far this season, Billy Clifford, mostly from the bench, and again, some of their players, you can just understand having a short fuse, and there's the frustration, didn't need to do that, left his foot in, and you could see what was going on, especially how quickly the Eastleigh players reacted, and at 5-2, it just goes from bad to worse for Ebbsfleet. Not what you want to see, especially on the end of what's been really quite a good game of football.
It's stupid. It was going straight to McDonald's hands and then off the ball. Clifford dangled a leg, kicked out an Eastleigh defender, and it's really, really naive of him at this stage in the game.
Into the final minute of the additional five. You expect maybe a little bit more now with the red card as well. Go on a red card, an additional five. Who would have thought? Might be going in till tomorrow now. Ball is back with Cousins, who has had another five go past him this season. That's 27 conceded for the campaign for him. And over halfway, Ebbsfleet now reduced to 10 men. You'd expect that they're just going to play it around, stop Eastleigh from getting a sixth. As Cisse just, it's very pedestrian pace now from Ebbsfleet. They know that they've been done here. O'Neill on halfway. And, well, whilst they're just playing it around the back, Jack, this is exactly what Eastleigh need now to just continue their climb up the table, exactly like the step up that they needed.
Absolutely, and you know, it's still very early on in the season, but Eastleigh are mid-table, and with this very comfortable win, they can kick on, as you say, Tom, and perhaps make a bit of a push for the playoffs. But it's such a competitive league, isn't it? There's so many ex-Football League teams, and you know, Eastleigh, if they can just get on a run of games and be there or thereabouts at the end of the season, it'll be
very good year for the Spitfires.
I have to say, a lot of people on social media not necessarily pleased with the appointment of Richard Hill, but two games in permanent charge, 8 goals scored, 2 wins. Not really much to complain about at the moment for the Spitfires. Grendel has it, and Eastleigh are just going to see this one out. You'd expect the referee's whistle to blow any minute now. But we are still going here into the October night as there's a coming together, and this could be a chance if Maguire can just feed it through to Boldervine. He's still going, Maguire. 25 yards out, shapes to shoot, onto his left foot, and plays it back to Quigley. Is he going to have a go at goal? Taylor out towards that far side now to Oscar Rutherford, who's only had a couple of touches since coming on in place of Paul McCallum, and Eastleigh now are just going to slow things down. A few triangles in and around the centre of the pitch, just waiting for the win to be confirmed, and I'd imagine that to be any second now. But we are, as it stands, we're in the 7th minute of the 5 added on. Rendell heads it across the back. Francheletta will collect, and it's going to be a happy Tuesday night for Eastleigh. Next few games for them, Hartlepool away next weekend, and of course FA Cup action against Dover Athletic. 4th qualifying round, we'll also bring you coverage of that live on BBC Radio Solent. Myself and Wayne Shaw here for that one.
Not sure why the ref's taking this long, Tom. I mean, the game's done. The game's absolutely done. Ebbsfleet are just letting Eastleigh have the ball. There must have been about 30 passes in this spell. I think there it is.
There we go. There's the full-time whistle. Let the silver lay. A fantastic 5 for Eastleigh. A wonderful night for the Spitfires under the lights. Paul McCallum, the hero of the evening. A hat-trick for him. Scott Quigley with a beautiful finish in there as well, and a Chris Maguire penalty to be the cherry on top of the icing, on top of the cake. Jack, a very enjoyable evening with you.
Very enjoyable evening, Tom, indeed. And you mentioned before the game that both teams score a lot of goals, and we've got a 7 in total this evening. And unfortunately for Eastleigh fans, Eastleigh with the 5 goals, Ebbsfleet with the 2. But again, mentioned that trio of Maguire, Quigley, and I think it was Boldervine as well, and obviously McCallum in there. Fantastic evening for all those three. They were really effective, created loads of chances. McCallum showing his quality in the air, 3 headers for a hat trick, and again promising signs for Eastleigh as they continue this push for the playoffs.
Very solid for Eastleigh. That now makes it 4 wins out of their last 6 matches. Really, really solid after what was a very sort of tentative stop-start beginning to their campaign. But with the squad that they've got available to them, they're now starting to realise that potential.
Yeah, definitely. And the strength of the depth coming off the bench as well. The likes of Rutherford and Taylor in there. It's an experienced Eastleigh side, and they really did do a job on Ebbsfleet tonight, who, albeit the first 10-15 minutes, played the better football. But it's all very well playing the better football, but you have to be effective, and Eastleigh were more effective in both boxes. McCallum, every time he got near the ball inside the 18-yard box, it was a goal. Quigley, his tireless work off the ball was exceptional, and Carter as well, fantastic. A couple of assists for him, and topping it off with the penalty from Maguire as well. So plenty of positive signs for Eastleigh. Really dominant display tonight.
And of course, it could have even been 6 with Scott Quigley hitting the post as well.
It could have, and it would have been goal of the month, I think you said, Tom, and quite rightly so. And, you know, the tireless work off the ball, it has to be said, for Eastleigh. Second half, they came out and really pressed Ebbsfleet. They didn't allow them to play, which is what they wanted to do. And the amount of times Ebbsfleet gave it away in dangerous areas for Eastleigh, and culminating in the Boldervine penalty at the end there. But, fantastic performances from Eastleigh all over the park. And, again, really good signs this for the Spitfires moving forward.
Thank you very much for your company this evening, Jack. It's been an absolute pleasure having you along.
Always a pleasure, Tom.
And it's a wonderful evening for Richard Hill and the Spitfires. Eastleigh victors by 5-2 in the National League. I'm going to hand you back to the studio in just a moment. Spitfires fans, if you want to get your texts and tweets into Jordan Clark at Solent Sport on X, formerly known as Twitter. And of course, if you want to send in a text, that's 81333. Start your message with the word Solent. Full time here at the Silver Lake, Eastleigh 5, Ebbsfleet 2.